I'm like Gene Simmons. Yeah. Constantly, you know, if there's something to promote, you got to get it in
no,
there.
No,
right?
But you.
No, that looks like your own hair, first of all.
It's not a helmet.
You're not 80 years old.
The thing is, Opie and Anthony, is that this is my real hair.
That's it. Oh, God.
He's hard to even compliment because you're like, I love Gene, but like, even when you're being nice to him, he just has to be a dick by accident.
Yeah.
By proxy.
Oh, I got a Gene Simmons story that I can tell now. Remember when that fucking douchebag Gene Simmons was here that day? And he was over at Channel 11 before.
Mm-hmm.
He was giving Jill all kinds of fucking shit, like trying to pick up on her and everything. And then he made like he didn't really know anything was going on. And then he goes, oh, maybe I'll just go and fuck your girlfriend. He went over there and actually made a harassing problem over there where her boss had to come up to Jill and ask if there was a problem. Because Gene, like, pinned her against the wall.
Wow.
And was being really, like, physical and very, very nasty.
Really?
And, yeah. Yeah.
Hmm.
And I was like, you know, what the fuck? Gene, sit that fucking cocksucker. And then it's like, yeah, well, you know, what I'll be doing tonight. And he goes, yeah, well, I'll be fucking your girlfriend. And it's like, no, Gene, first of all, I'll be. And secondly, you know, she thinks, you know, you're fucking old hack douche.
Wait, Anthony, was it before or after he was here?
It was minutes before he was sitting there.
Did he know it was your chick when he was pinning her?
Yes!
Oh, okay.
Of course he did!
How do you know?
He knew. Because he had fucking, or there was a discussion about that beforehand.
Oh, wow.
And she had said, you know, knock it off. I have a boyfriend, shit like that. And he wouldn't fucking stop. He wouldn't stop being the fucking egotistical prick that he thinks everybody thinks he deserves.
It must be hard for him, though, now that he's old and ugly with bad hair, that he still thinks he can be Gene Simmons from 1982.
That he's getting every fucking chick.
It's
yes, Danny?
Do you remember when he was in and he was sitting to my left? And I have these big computer screens in front of me, and you know, during interviews or whatever, like I'll try and research stuff and everything.
Yeah.
So I guess I was trying to type quietly,
right?
But he still kind of heard a little bit of the, you know.
Yeah, the keyboard.
And it annoyed him so much that he actually put his hand like under the monitor and put his hand on my hand, like, stop doing that while I'm talking.
But the thing is, he didn't even skip a beat as he was talking. He's like, and the latest thing I'm hawking and trying to sell. And as he's talking, he he just put his hand over on Danny's hand. His hand said, knock that the fuck off, but his mouth was still selling his fucking wares.
Didn't even look in my direction, just took his hand, just went under the monitor and grabbed my hand, like, stop doing that.
Don't get me wrong, I don't care if all of Kiss fucked her right now. I'm just saying, at the time, don't fuck with, you know, the girl that I'm going with at the time.
I'm confused,
though,
Anthony.
He disrespected me, and he was being a fucking cocksucker.
I'm confused, though. Do you like Gene Simmons?
No, Gene Simmons is a fucking cunt.
Wow.
That's what my official stance on Gene Simmons is now. Gene Simmons is a cunt.
Jimmy's
no,
crying.
The guy fucking knew. And he was bullshitting and trying to play me like a fucking sap as I sat here not knowing what happened yet. I knew right afterwards what happened, but I had no idea what happened. He knew, and he's fucking like trying to play me off as the dim-witted fucking ignorant asshole that doesn't know what's going on. Fuck you, you old cocksucker. Fuck you. Your porno looked like shit, too. You don't know how to fuck if you ever did. If you ever did, you don't know how to fuck anymore. Get any girl that you fucked, I'll fuck her, and they'll go, that's a fucking. The thing I got from Gene Simmons wasn't a fucking.
What was wrong with his technique?
What?
What was wrong with his technique?
He's got no stamina. He's got nothing. He's fucking just a load fucking blobbing back and forth. Make some moves. Twist some shit around. Make the girl happy, you dumb fuck. Put your face down there.
First of all, he put a condom on, bad.
Oh, put a condom on.
It was a Kiss condom.
Oh, what? Yeah, he put a Kiss condom on.
He probably fucks like the teacher from Forrest Gump.
Yeah.
Wait, I got to move Danny up the list.
That's good.
Danny, I'm moving you up the list.
That's good. You're up David's list.
That's good. All
right.
Maybe I can be funnier than Simmons.
Steve.
Yeah.
That'd be nice.
You already are. You said something.
Gene Simmons.
My loyalty is with Anthony. I love Gene, but my loyalty will always be with Anthony.
How loyal, though? Go home. You got some... memorabilia from Kiss. Are you willing to throw it in?
Wow.
Are you willing to throw it in the dumpster? Hold on.
He should bring it in tomorrow and throw it away.
Bring in your Kiss memorabilia tomorrow, Jimmy.
I wouldn't bring that in if he had harassed Anthony's mother and my mother. I'm not getting rid of my Kiss shit.
But there is loyalty there, right?
Loyalty.
Yeah, I love it.
Loyalty in here is
there. But you're not bringing the memorabilia.
No! Gene signed that stuff for me.
We need a Gene memorabilia Bernie tomorrow.
That's it.
I could agree with my friend Anthony on one hand, but
I'm very loyal.
Gene, it's signed.
Wherever Anthony stands on it, I'm with him. That's it.
I understand your point with saying, did he know beforehand and stuff, which would be like
did he find out when, did she, this is the only reason I'm asking is because, like, was he hassling her, and she, I have a boyfriend, and he doesn't give a fuck. And then finally, at the end, she finally said, my boyfriend is Anthony from the Opie and Anthony show. Maybe that's what stopped it. That's why I was asking.
He knew right away.
Oh, okay.
He was persistent on it. And he kept, and it was harassment on his part to where her boss had to come over to her and ask her what happened. Like, people were saying that Gene was harassing you and stuff. And, yeah. And then he comes in here and fucking looking me right in the eyes and playing me like that. Well, maybe I'll just fuck your girlfriend. Like, and I laughed because it's like, oh, I'm thinking he doesn't even know who the fuck she is or anything. But he knew exactly everything, and he's fucking playing me off like that. Okay. Go fuck yourself, you fucking old man. Cocksucker. Go franchise your shit little makeup band out and make a few more bucks.
Wow.
Drop dead rich. Good. Good for you. Look at Gene fucking in his porno. Good job. That's
t-shirt.
Good. Yeah, lift the gut up. There you go. Now your dick can fit in.
Who's the girl?
She's fantastic.
She's got big boobies.
Yeah, I don't know. Look at his slow motion fucking.
I love the fact he's wearing a t-shirt and socks, and his pants are down still.
Oh, God. It's like the old mangy lion plowing the fucking lioness on the Serengeti. You know that old mangy lion? It's his last year as top of the pride.
Wow, you've been holding this in for a while.
Fuck Gene Simmons.
Ever touch a raw nerve here.
Wow. Can we have a Kiss song, please? Which one you like? Lick It Up, which one you want today?
Oh, give me one with Gene singing.
Yeah.
Great Expectations.
Or Dr. Love.
Yeah. Here you go.
Dr. Love, man.
Dr. Love. Go ahead. Climb aboard that fucking broad in your porno. Go ahead. Boy, you must be proud of that one. His flat fucking saggy ass is moving like it looks like two old droopy doilies swinging in the breeze on a clothesline. That's what his ass looks like as he's fucking this hot chick.
Droopy doilies.
Oh, you know he'd be getting her if he wasn't Gene Simmons from Kiss. You know that. Absolutely. There's Gene. That's it. The old lion. Punch up an old lion fucking a lioness. And that's what Gene looks like.
You nailed that bitch.
Bro's on the money over there, man. He pulled that up instantly.
That's it, Gene. Goddamn. As long as you can get through one fucking without your hair falling off, I guess it's okay. I guess it's a victory.
Droopy doilies.
There you go.
That's the line of the day.
Oh, after he ate the girl's pussy, she thought she forgot to shave. But it was just Gene's wig fell in her lap.
Do you guys still do the line of the day?
Oh, yeah.
Because you just heard it right there.
Wow. Nice.
Fuck you, Gene Simmons.
Pinned her up against the wall, huh?
Yeah. Like, pinned her against the fucking wall.
Was there any booby touching going on?
I think he was, like, trying. She was pushing his hands down because he was trying to put his hands around her waist. And it was like, in the main office part where everyone could see everything. And people were looking, and it was like, oh, this is weird. What the fuck is Gene doing?
Are you mad
that... Pretty much getting close to molesting somebody.
Are you mad that you didn't know when he came in here?
That's what pissed me off the most, is that he fucking looked at me, and he knew, and he's fucking straight-faced, pitching all of his wares. I'm sitting there giving him the time of day and a forum to pitch his fucking bullshit on, and he's playing me like a sap, like a sucker. Fuck him. Fuck you, Gene.
I think you should get Gene in studio and you can...
Oh, if Gene came in here, I would fucking hold back. I'd say the same fucking thing. Whether he was on the phone or fucking in the studio, I would say the same fucking thing to him. Because that pissed me off. He tried to play me. And he'd be all, well, listen, well, I don't... And I wouldn't let him fucking sit there and do that. No way. No fucking way.
Get Gene Simmons on the show when Jimmy's out of town.
Go ahead, as soon as possible.
Norton would get his autograph.
I've got it already. I would be right here with Anthony. I would not as much Gene. as he was here, but I would be completely with you.
And in spirit, you wouldn't actually say that.
And all that memorabilia, you're going to bring that in tomorrow, Jimmy?
Gene Simmons memorabilia. That's good.
No. Would you break something else from your collection in honor of the fact that Ann hates
pull
Gene
that
Simmons?
Fucking, pull that wig off, add two guys, and you have a lemon party. No shit. Fuck you.
Don't mess with Ed.
Oh, there he is, right?
Is that really him without his hair?
That's good. That's
well, some say it is, and others say that it was a stunt. Right. Like yeah, he was put a bald cap on.
Oh, did he?
Oh, really?
Yeah. Go play keyboards for Letterman.
Well,
fuck yourself.
Why don't we?
Fuck your mother.
Let's give an open invite to Gene Simmons to come back on our show to comment on what Ann is saying today.
No problem.
And in between commenting, we'll let you plug a few of your shitty products.
Yeah, what would he be fucking plugging now?
Besides other
Besides trying to plug friends. Trying to plug my ex-girlfriend.
Can we get Gene Simmons on the phone at least?
For when?
Like now would be good.
Yeah, he's waiting.
I can see if he's up.
Huh?
I can see if they're up.
No, yeah, he needs his Betty bye.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. Tell him to do a shot of Geritol and get his ass on the phone. Yeah, fuck him.
I'll say, Anthony, I'm upset with you, but buy my new DVD.
No, sir, what I was doing, no, you don't understand. This is what I do. See, this is what I do. I know these guys.
He would say something like that. You're absolutely right.
It's just what I do. I don't know. Why are you getting so upset? Why are you so upset?
I didn't actually fuck her.
Yeah, he'd do that passive-aggressive bullshit that he does. Why get upset, Anthony? Why? I don't understand.
She's a big
girl. Where's this hostility coming from? If she wanted to fuck me, she would have fucked me. But since she didn't, where's the problem?
He's got his fucking
voice. And it would be
down.
Like, it would be like, well, Gene, you came over here and started fucking with me. You didn't tell me shit about that. And then playing me off like I'm a fucking sap by telling me you're going to go and fuck my girlfriend that night where no one was in on the joke except you and your ego? Go fuck yourself.
You know what he would say.
What?
How do you know she didn't want it?
How do you know? They all want it from Gene. Just watch my video.
They're all dogs.
Look at my video. It looks fantastic. As I lay there. Ugh. Just fuck it. Oh, my God. Being ravaged by that. That fucking ball sack must scrape on the rug like melted Turkish taffy.
We're supposed to be interviewing Chris Jericho.
Oh, I'm sorry, Chris. And you're, that TV show, where, when is that?
I don't know if we compete with droopy doilies.
He's got doily ass and Turkish taffy balls.
All I have to say is thank God it wasn't Ozzy, because then it would be really confusing in here today.
No, no.
Thank God it's
Ozzy wouldn't do that.
Ozzy's a respectful man.
Ozzy has respect.
You know what it was? It was the lack of respect for me. He disrespected me.
Especially as a guest on your show.
Yes, as a guest on my show. Thank you, Chris.
Absolutely.
As a guest on the show. And he disrespected me, knew he was disrespecting me, and did it in a way where he knew I didn't know the situation, so I couldn't even fight back, which is a pussy-ass fucking punk move.
Nice. Let's go to the phones.
Yes.
People want to defend Gene Simmons here. Greg in New Hampshire.
Oh, hey, the day of that original interview, I was getting douche chills. Like, you can't even believe. I called a few times so you guys would trash him. And I'm so glad I'm still listening to hear it now, because he is such a douchebag. Thank you.
Good. When does the fucking Gene Simmons kiss penis implant come out? So maybe you could fuck a little better. You are one lousy fuck from the look of it. Oh, God. That's his sex music. That's what girls like. A nice fucking fuck that they could use a grandfather clock pendulum to fuck by. A metronome with the fucking weight way up top. That's what they want to see. Tick tock. Tick tock. Change it up a little, Gene.
Do you fuck faster or harder?
I do it all.
Do you?
Slow, fast. I like poking a little and then whomp, the slow drive.
And then fast. And then one leg's up. The other leg's up. They're both down. Flip over. We'll do it this way. I'm on my back. She's on her back. We're both on our fucking head. Against the headboard. Against the bed. I don't give a shit. And, I'm fucking.
And in comparison, Gene Simmons.
That's how we fuck. Slow and steady wins the race. Okay, how about I go and fuck your girlfriend? No.
He's turning dopey.
Oh, fuck me harder. Fuck me harder, Gene.
No.
I think the three of us could just leave and let Andy talk to us for another hour.
Had it. And Gene Simmons, enough of him already.
He's getting a lot of publicity. He would love this.
Oh, yeah, he would.
There's no such thing as bad publicity, Anthony.
No, all publicity is good publicity.
Bringing everybody back to Kiss.
That's what it is.
The greatest rock and roll band ever.
It all comes back to Kiss.
Shut it.
That's really...
Fucking Gene.
Glad we got that out.
Man,
there.
Man. That was purged. That's
I'm
been
surprised
purged.
I forgot about that.
Yeah, well, now you're never going to forget it now.
How did I forget that?
Do you want the audience to Google bomb something? Gene Simmons.
Gene Simmons, lousy lay.
Nah, we can do better than that.
Really?
Yeah, that is pretty
Gene
bad.
Gene Simmons wig.
Our problem is most of our listeners don't know how to spell lousy.
Yeah, that's true.
They'll mess it all
or
up.
Gene.
They'd have Gene Simmons living in Laos.
Right. J-A-N-S.
I don't know what happened. Gene Simmons went to Laos? He's got lice.
How about it?
No. Could just throw it in the washing machine.
How about a simple F Gene Simmons?
That's good. Yeah. I don't care.
What do you got?
I'd had it with him by that point. And then I'd had it with him when he was sitting there. I was just being gracious because, again, as Chris had pointed out, he's a guest on the show. After I found out, I was like so pissed that I didn't get a chance to like jump on him for that whole fucking episode.
Because you had no idea.
No, that's the point. I didn't know.
And would have unloaded in front of him, guaranteed.
Yeah. Fuck yeah.
He didn't know.
Oh, that's got to be a treat into the girl's ear. That's got to be a treat. Oh. Sorry, Jim, I'm kind of using your bit, but
that's all right.
Oh, the Gene Simmons. Oh, after that fucking lousy fuck.
Does it end with a blurka, blurka, blurka?
Blurka, blurka. Oh, just no muscles left to launch any jizz. It just must dribble out. Oh.
Like lava.
Oh, it's just got to be horrible. You know when you turn the hose off first and then take the nozzle off?
Lava.
And it just goes glug, glug over the top of your hand.
Lava after the eruption.
Oh, yeah.
Just a blurka,
the volcano's
blurka, blurka.
Long been dormant.
It's very bubbly.
Just pours over the edge every so often. A glurg, glurg, glurg. Misfire. Fuck.
Can I just say, out of all the radio interviews I've done, that your microphones smell the nicest? Do you guys have spray?
Oh, people have to do that beforehand.
Man, that's really nice smell. It's like you've washed these overnight.
A little lava coming down the mountain. A glurg, glurg, glurg. It's lava moving so slowly, people can just walk by it. That's Gene.
Man, you're on the case, man. He's pulling up all this great stuff.
I'm feeling I'm going to come. give me another 10 minutes. Glurg, glurg. Please.
Was Jill upset at the time?
Yeah, she wasn't very happy about that.
She's the type of girl
that
could take care of herself. But
yeah, she did. She took care of herself.
And management actually went to her and said, "Look,
yeah, said was there a problem that we should know about and stuff because it was so blatant and like."
What gave it away? She was
invasive.
What gave it away? She was taking a shower, scrubbing.
She's sitting in a cold tub, just quietly weeping.
Right. I don't want to use the word, but type of shower. Got to get the filth off me.
I can't get over what a good fuck Anthony probably is. That, but can I, honest to God, fuck much more like Gene does. I'm a little worse lay. Like I'm mediocre because I'm so high maintenance. I have to just go slow and you have to play with my nipples because I've desensitized myself jerking off so badly.
I'm going
to
go back to Jimmy now.
I enjoy
Jimmy.
The fucking
Ant's got a problem with Gene Simmons. Coincidentally, you got a book called I Hate Your Guts.
Yes.
There will be a paperback, and you know how you got to add some new material in the paperback. Will there be
an appendix?
A Gene Simmons chapter in honor of Anthony.
I would
like to see that.
I would happily
actually, I actually put a gene amendment in the old book in Happy Endings because it was whatever. But I would happily, if Anthony wrote something and wanted to put it in.
Oh,
I would,
oh you won't write it though.
No, it wouldn't be as funny if I wrote because Anthony's angry.
I would love to.
I would happily put it under my name.
But you're the author. I think you know you should write it.
Oh, would I love to write that?
No, but with Anthony, to just transcribe what he said.
Yeah, just take the tape of the show.
I don't think you have to. You couldn't do any better than that.
I would happily for Anthony put any type of in the paperback. Would love to.
Thank you, Jim.
That's not a bad angle.
It's a great angle.
I would love to get Jill's side of the story.
What?
What would it take for Jim Norton to, you know?
I don't know. I'd have to meet him in public or in person.
We haven't met,
see if that's there. Yeah, we've never actually met in person.
Well, Katie, this is Gene Simmons, and I know you'd fuck me. I know you'd absolutely fuck me because
I didn't know you were there either.
I'm so fantastic.
Yeah, we...
I heard you're a bad lay, though.
Yes, I'm horrible. I'm terrible at fucking.
But you make up for it in the other department.
No, I make up for it nowhere. I'm a pompous ass.
Ew.
I'm jealous. I'm conceited.
Dude, and, did he piss you guys off or what?
And I fuck like I should be in a retirement home.
Yes, so don't piss us off, Katie.
See, no, I won't because I am a good lay. I don't need that rumor being spread.
All right.
It looks more like Gene Simmons.
Oh, you had to bring up Gene Simmons.
Slowly I turn, step by step.
What, you don't like Gene Simmons?
Gene Simmons is a piece of crap. What a douche he is.
You didn't mention Gene Simmons.
I've never had an opinion on him either
Gene
way.
Gene Simmons is a self-serving,
here we go,
sellout douchebag who is also a phony, a liar, and a creep.
But how do you feel about him as a person?
He disrespected me personally by trying to pick up on my girlfriend, knowing it was my girlfriend, coming on my show, and then screwing with me about it without me knowing that he was trying to do this. My chick was all upset at the time because he was like pinned her against a wall pretty much and was being very forward.
Right.
And then he comes on the show and I was like, oh, well, so what are you doing tonight? He goes, maybe I'll just F your girlfriend. And I kind of laughed because I figured he didn't know who my girlfriend was or anything like that. But he did, and he was talking to her and trying to pick up on her like this old bat would do. Just anything to try to keep his lousy ego going. And it was just, I'm broken up with her now, so I don't care if he just bangs the hell out of her.
Right,
whatever.
Right.
Give her a good one. Well, you know, that's but at the time, it was nothing but sheer disrespect for me, and Gene Simmons can kiss my balls.
Well, he can probably lick your ass at the same time.
Exactly. Thank you.
Did I just get... That was a good
line,
though.
We both got dumped out, but I figured...
They heard it. They heard it on the internet and satellite. Yeah. Don't worry about it.
I just... The guy...
Gene Simmons tongue joke.
I despise him for doing that to me, because it was... I took it very personally that he... He went and personally disrespected me as he's on my show plugging more of his KISS garbage. More of his KISS garbage. What are you selling now? What are you selling now, huh? KISS Geritol? Why don't you do that? Wrap the KISS logo around Geritol. Just call it KISS Energy for ancient people. And his stupid porno that he made, you see that?
No.
Did you see that anticlimactic piece of garbage that he did?
I'm getting comfortable for this.
I don't like repeating things and stuff, but it's the best way to describe it. Like, do you ever see a National Geographic when they show the old lion on it's his last like year as head of the pride, and he's nailing the lioness, and he just does that romp, romp, romp kind of a motion? That's Gene Simmons porno. He doesn't know how to have sex with a woman properly and make her feel good. He doesn't. I'm sorry. I was watching the video and going, that has got to be the most unsatisfied woman ever. But I'm Gene Simmons. Look at my tongue. I know how to... Just stop. If you wouldn't use it half the time for yapping about some candy bar that's coming out or a credit card with the logo on it or who you're suing for saying the word kiss... Jackass. I hear he goes to carnivals and has kissing booths closed. That's my band's name. It's KISS. I don't... Jackass.
Thanks, Jim. Thank you. Yeah. For bringing up Gene Simmons.
I have a surprise for you, Anthony.
Huh?
I have a surprise for Anthony.
What?
Gene, come on in.
That's good. Good.
That would
let him come in.
That would rule.
Let him come in.
That would rule.
Ass.
That lion.
There it is. Look at that lion. That is the most lackluster lay that lioness has ever gotten. Hello. How are you? Have you bought the Gene Simmons Kiss coffin? Where are you going?
Oh, they do sell coffins, don't they?
Oh, of course they do.
I saw that on the show.
She just went to lay down after the lion gave
it to
her.
That's what Gene should have been laying in when he had sex with that broad. Hey, maybe they thought she was dead. Well.
All right. Rollins last night.
Suffice to say, I'm not a Gene Simmons fan.
No. Oh, he'll have a rebuttal.
Will he?
Yeah, he'll be brave enough to try to call the show.
Oh, yeah.
You're
going
to lose
Why so angry?
You're going to lose
Anthony.
This one.
Why so angry?
Rollins last day, the boys put together.
Shill.
Just don't mention Gene Simmons in front of.
That jackass.
Don't mention Gene
really?
Simmons.
You know, he was at the premiere for Role Models because there's a whole kiss theme in the movie.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah, of course he was. Was he selling anything in a cart out in front? Kiss friggin' buttons or something?
Why? What happened?
Well, we should not talk about it.
Okay. I'll bring it up. After the break.
After the break, you'll explain it to Sean William Scott.
Quickly, I'll give it the brief version. I won't go off like I did the other day.
And we were all fans. You know, we're not going to, you know, fake that here, but,
I was never a big Kiss fan. I like two of their hits.
Love Gun?
Yeah, like stuff like that that everyone knows. You're the probably obscure like, stuff, I'm like, I don't care.
You probably like Beth. Remember, he even had to take credit for that song, even though it was Peter Criss's
that
moment.
That was my song. I actually came up and named the song Beth and said, shut up.
That's a good impression.
Oh,
that's
the
awesome.
Guy is just constantly just trying to sell and take credit for everything. His sex tape was pathetic.
Oh, gross. He's got a sex tape?
Oh, yeah.
I told you not to bring it up, Sean Williams.
Sorry.
Get a nice lumbering lay from the old baldy.
Oh, my gosh.
Well, he has a very good reason why.
I want to hear it.
All right, we'll tell you after the break. And, William Scott, one of our friends, we could say that now. His new movie, Role Models, comes out this Friday. We're all excited to see that one. Thanks, we haven't seen the last two, but we're going to see this one.
Okay, it was worth the wait. This is a better one.
And I'm serious. I got to go check it out. I'm hoping to get a copy ahead of time.
Yeah, we got to go to the theater. We need the business.
All right, I'll go to the theater. What the hell?
We'll get a big group of guys and friends together.
That's how it works.
You know what's great about him? He gets very excited to come on our show, and he needs to know everything that has gone on since the last time he's been here, because he knows we're going to have good stories for him.
Oh, sure.
Oh, he's like, you still seeing that girl from the news thing? I was like, oh, no.
Well,
so I told him that whole story, that whole sordid story of fire in the backyard.
I feel so boring. I hear these stories. I'm like, I got to get out. We got a party.
Insane.
What part did you like of that story?
The story?
I told it on the air.
I think
so,
it's fine. I think my favorite is just her opening up the walk-in closet.
The closet door.
I can imagine being in that situation where you just know she goes to the one and you're like, well, okay. So, but is it going to keep going? And then just the fact that she opens the other one and she's like, hi. What she say? Like, she goes, hello.
She went, hello. How long have you been my boyfriend? And then the girl gave her an answer, 3 weeks.
Were we secretly really happy? Like, was it kind of awesome?
Yeah, I was trying to figure out a way to end it, but I'm not an end it kind of guy. I can't just walk up and go, we're through. I've had it. I'm enough with you, and I find you're a little too demanding for my...
He doesn't believe in diplomacy. He believes in atom bombs.
Atom bombs forever.
A definite end.
It was just one of those situations where I found out, like, every day of my life was being planned out. Like, here, this is Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
Oh,
and,
no.
Like, Thursday'd roll around. I'm like, I just kind of want to sit around and watch TV or something.
Oh,
it's like,
delicious.
Oh, but we have this and that and that. Oh, this weekend. Like, everything was manic and crazy and how to do this, that, and the other thing. I'm just like, I can't take
this. You weren't ready. That's all. You want a relationship.
Yeah,
you want to be single,
didn't.
You know?
And I was
do the family thing, right? Did you have to hear with the family?
And you're
yeah.
Oh.
A lot of family stuff. I'm a homosexual? What? apparently, that's what she said. She goes, so you go out with a girl with a body like a boy? Is that what it is? You like young boys? What are you, gay? Oh, Uncle Paul.
What are you, gay?
Wow.
Nice one.
Like, she couldn't fathom.
Because that makes a lot of sense, since you've been sleeping with this girl for 3 weeks.
That I was, doing something like that.
You must be gay.
With that, so I got to be, I'm quite a fruit. And, that got out of hand with the burning of property and the prisoner exchange and having to pay for dry
dead guy ashes.
Dead guy ashes, yeah.
Still in the fire pit.
All the features. All the features. And then,
I didn't tell the story when it happened because she didn't want like anything getting out and a big hassle being made with the Gene Simmons thing. But then since we broke up and I was reminded of it the other day, I got all pissed off. But after the fact, Gene Simmons came on our show, as he usually does, to hawk some crap, to hawk some garbage with the KISS logo on it. And he had just been over at the CW 11 doing an interview over there to hawk his crap. So my girlfriend at the time, she was working over there, as we all know, and he walked up to her, and this office is like all glass and everything, so everyone's seeing, and like kind of with his body, pins her against the wall and starts like trying to grab at her and asking, hey, we'll go out tonight. What are you doing this evening? Me and you. You know, I really find you attractive and I think we should go out. And she's like, I have a boyfriend. I don't care. I have a, you know, girlfriend who I'm free and open to all sexual experiences. You know, it is his psycho babble Gene Simmons crap. So she goes, no. She goes, as a matter of fact, you're going over there to do an interview with my boyfriend. He's Anthony from the Opie and Anthony show. He goes, well, whatever. He didn't care or anything like that.
No way.
So he's pulling all this crap, and it got so bad that her boss actually went over to her and asked, was there a problem? Like, we were watching, and it seemed like you were having a problem with Gene. She goes, I handled it. You know, but yeah, he was being very forward and very, like, weird. Trying to touch and weird and everything like that.
In front of everybody? Like,
yeah, yeah.
Like a morning show, too, right?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. It was like, so then he comes over onto our show, sits down, and now he knows exactly that. It was my girlfriend that he's doing that to. I didn't know that he knew. So we're talking and stuff, and
but you had no clue that
no,
that
would happen. Okay, no, so well, I didn't know yet.
Interviewing Gene Simmons.
So now I'm there. I'm the host of a show that he's on now, hawking his goods, and he starts this whole thing with because I go, so what are you going to be doing tonight? He goes, maybe I'll be effing your girlfriend. Now, and I laugh.
No.
And I laugh because I'm like, oh, if you only knew like who my girlfriend was.
No way.
And he's like, oh yeah, well, so now it's a complete disrespect on me. And stuff, and I'm not even into that low, yo, you're disrespecting me. But it was a complete lack of respect. Like, he's in on this little secret and thinks he's got this shot at the time. And he does now, and I don't care. But, like, at the time.
She can burn.
Yeah, she seems to have burnt my wig in the fire pit. So he's pulling, like, that crap on me.
So did he do it, like, where... Like he was actually just like, I'm literally going to hook up with your girlfriend.
Yeah, he actually thought that he was going to hook up with her that night.
Wow.
Like that's what he did. And he was playing me with that whole thing.
What a jerk.
Like to himself. It wasn't even a joke that anyone knew about. Like he, to his own ego, him and his ego were having a good laugh about the whole thing. So I just sat there and didn't know. And then when I found out, he was already gone. So now I'm just like, if that son of a bitch wants to come on the show to hawk his crap, let him on. Don't tell him anything, and I'm blindsiding him
for the
cheap, friggin' selfish, money grubbing sea sucker that he is. And I saw his sex tape; it got out, and he is the worst lay ever. Always talking about, yes, the passion of Gene Simmons.
No,
I get girls, and, you know, I'm in an open relationship, and I can have sex with whoever I want. And who would want it? you mangy old puma.
That's how you really feel.
He's just that doing this weird, slow though. Little chugunk, chug. Like all mouth.
Here it is.
Yeah, look at him. Look at him. What is
ka-junk.
That? I said it before.
No.
I'll say it again. It's like one of the old lion on the Serengeti getting his last year as head of the pride.
Oh, that's terrible. When did this
it's
come out?
Horrible.
What is this?
Ka-chunk.
That's
ka-chunk.
Gene Simmons.
Ka-chunk.
There you go.
Ka-chunk.
Wow. That's... You're really going at it,
ka-chunk.
Gene.
No ka-chunk. Ka-chunk.
All the stamina of a sloth.
I thought that was Steve.
God.
Oh, my gosh. That's disturbing.
Yeah.
Jeez, did you have to smack her and wake her up during that?
Wow, that is so weird.
Gene Simmons.
Where did that thing come out? It was on purpose, right? He just like...
It's one of those, let me make my career because I'm dying over here. Let me do a sex tape and let it out.
Now for Sean William Scott, now you got the comparison.
Yeah, that's what he looks like. Look, here's Gene.
Here's the lion.
There's the lion. And that's exactly what
it is. Dunk, dunk.
There it is. Hello. Waiting for some young lion to take his pride from him.
Same hair too.
Let me bite you on the neck. What, you didn't like that? And there she goes, a way to lay down.
Ryan.
All right, leave me alone. But I'm Gene Simmons.
type. Don't do. Wait, I can't do Gene Simmons.
Shit.
You have to just be keep talking, and then put your hand over his hand. Like there's a problem. Like you're distracting such a genius.
Shut it.
I'm sorry. Just don't bring up Gene Simmons on the show ever.
God.
Fucking, is there any kind of Kiss box set or something coming? I got to get him to sign it. Wait, that's the wrong thing to say.
Yeah.
That's probably, that would be, to sign it.
Got
to
get him
in. Jab the pen through his neck.
Hey, look, you should tell him we got to come on. Anthony's got a problem with you.
Oh, yeah.
Seriously.
No, what's your problem? Why would you have a problem? With his soft-spoken, fucking passive-aggressive bullshit that he does all the time.
You know what?
I'll unload like a maniac on him. I don't care.
Just like you did on Mancow?
I gave him the best call he ever had.
You made a valid point.
I made a valid point.
That was the greatest ever.
I was told that was a really good point and a good call, and God, what a dick I am.
Yeah.
I was supposed to, hit him then, right betwixt the eyes.
You're a fucking bad prank caller.
I stink.
You were really bad that day. I understand what you were going for.
You got Prince Albert in a can? Yes. All right, I'll be down to purchase it.
Yes, enjoy it.
Yeah.
Is your refrigerator running? Yes. Thank God, because power's been spotty in certain areas.
Do you have 10-pound balls? Yes. Good. I like a nice light bowling ball. I'll be down to bowl soon.
Two Jews walk into a bar. Really? Yes. Apparently they're both thirsty.
They said hi to the owner.
Yes.
I think they liked that one the best.
Of course they did. They understand quality when they hear it. Those fucking three miscreants outside.
When you have Gene come in, make sure Danny types really loudly.
Yeah. Oh,
that'll happen.
Oh, just type.
I'm going to bring in one of those keyboards from like 1987 where it's like you can't even try to type softly on the stick.
Clickety clackety.
It sounds like they're spring loaded for some reason. Yeah. Clank, clank, clank.
Clickety clack. Just bring in an old typewriter and for no reason just smack it. Ding, zip.
How did
get
any...
it to go?
Or an electric one, yeah.
How did anybody write on a typewriter? Isn't it amazing? I mean, I had one, but it's amazing.
Mechanical, where the force of your finger actually is making the little letter thing pop up. Nothing electric, just a fucking mechanical machine.
So you're bludgeoning the paper with it. Basically, the paper's being smashed with a letter.
It's being beaten with the alphabet.
Yeah. It's like the fucking machine has an arm with a letter, and it goes, here, fucko. Whack! Whack! Whack!
You're right, too, because it goes over the top before it hits the paper.
It's got to build up speed. Yeah. It comes around and builds up speed like an overhand right.
And here you go, whack!
That's the difference between myself and you guys, because when I was going to school, we all had laptops.
Oh, did you?
And you guys?
Well, we weren't all wealthy. We weren't all wealthy.
Not wealthy. It's just a generation thing.
Yes.
You guys went to school when they had the typewriters and stuff.
How do you have a laptop in school?
Because I'm younger
than
you guys.
Perhaps more than that, Ant. Oh, God damn it! I didn't get it.
Of course not.
What?
What's that?
My school had 12 fingers. Yeah, an extra finger.
What'd she type? 14,000 words a minute.
72 a minute.
No way.
She had 12 fingers. Whenever she ate chicken, we'd all fucking mock her. Go. Like that, and lick the sixth finger. She had a little baby finger.
Guys were a scream.
Yeah.
What a hoot.
Where, where'd you go to Panic High? Holy mackerel. Welcome to Laugh School USA.
That was good.
Not one to be had. That's the best you guys could do with a sixth finger?
Yeah, really.
Is this?
We were kids.
Spike was on TV. This is what he had to say.
Oh, boy.
What do you think he had to say?
I am very disappointed McCain did not win.
Yes.
Yeah.
Our children, your children, my children, sometime soon, within the next decade or so, are going to look back at this epic moment that occurred in America yesterday, and they're going to say to us, the older generation, what took you people so long? Do you ever think about that, what happened last night in terms of that?
I think about it all the time, but we cannot forget the 400 years of slavery. This is something that nobody wants to talk about. It's not taught in school.
Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. Fuck you, Spike Lee.
Let's see where he goes with it.
I don't know. I'm not fucking listening to slavery babble anymore. I'll listen to Jimmy's point he made earlier about recent racism that was in this country from people that are still alive that remember not being able to go into a diner, and that completely understandable.
That was a good point Jimmy made.
But exactly.
We all like that.
But
point
don't
today.
Pour your fucking slavery shit on my ass again. Fuck you, Spike Lee. It's over. That shit was over. The shit that happened afterwards, address it. And now it's gotten so much fucking better that there's a black guy as president. Rejoice. Be jubilant to my chagrin. But don't fucking, within his first goddamn statement, he brings up slavery again. Enough with the fucking slavery.
We better not play the second clip.
Oh, no, I want to hear the second clip.
No, I'm putting it away.
It's important. I would like to hear it. Cause
no, can't do it.
Opie, yeah. he might go somewhere you don't think he's going to go.
No.
It's like someone just sold their last one yesterday, the way they fucking talk about it. I'm sick of it.
All right, what the hell? It could be fun.
Yeah.
All this is came out of 400 years of slavery, which built this country. And we haven't been able to deal with that. How are you going to deal with everything else that came behind that? But as you're talking about historians, it's going to be BB and AB. BB is everything happened before Barack. AB is everything that happened in this country and the world.
Letters.
After Barack, it's a defining moment. BB and AB.
Yeah, he's trying to.
Is it? Are they going to think like that? Like fucking Jesus Christ. Again, another fucking subtle Jesus reference.
He's the black Jesus.
B.C. and A.D.
Everyone knows Jesus was black, so.
Well, of course. He's the second fucking coming of Jesus. This is the shit that annoys the fuck out of me. Not the fact that there's a black president. I was talking in the elevator. He might be the best fucking president ever. Who knows? I don't know what this guy's all about. He hasn't told anybody what he's all about. Might turn out that he's a great president, but it's fucking douchebags like Spike Lee that piss me off.
I love Spike. You don't like Spike Lee?
No, Spike's a fucking cunt.
I feel like he's a good director.
Spike Lee's a cunt.
Who do you hate more, Spike Lee or Gene Simmons?
Come on. Come on, Ant.
Come on, Ant. That's a rough one.
Let me think.
All right.
I have to weigh this out.
Spike just hates your heritage. He wouldn't fuck your girl.
Well, neither did Gene.
I know he wouldn't
but
try,
but he was trying.
Yeah. This is a rough one.
But now
one.
I don't care, so I hate Spike Lee.
More.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
So you have forgiven Gene Simmons?
Fuck no. He's a close second.
How was Ace?
Ace is great. Because Eddie's good friends with Ace, so Ace doesn't even remember any of the stories. So he's just said, tell that one. I don't remember it. He's like, I did that?
Really? You get a lot of that?
He likes. He gets along with Gene, actually, though. I thought they hated each other.
No. Did you just say who? Gene Simmons?
Yeah.
You didn't bring up Gene, did you?
Why?
Jackass.
Oh, my God. Here
That's
we go.
That bastard.
Oh, boy.
Ugh.
Who's mad at him?
Oh, Gene Simmons is a douchebag. He's just a tool. He's a self-promoting ass who thinks he could get whatever he wants in this world. But you can't, Gene, can you? You couldn't, could you?
No, I didn't really care until it hit him personally is what he's getting at.
One time he went over to WB11 and tried like picking up on my chick.
Yeah.
WB11, were you dating her in 97?
Or wherever it was.
CW11.
I should remember the C part of that.
Yeah.
Why don't you just say WPIX?
Yeah.
Really brought that back.
He was banging Phil Rizzuto.
Picks. Officer Joe Bolton. Going way back.
Yeah.
Captain McCarthy was his name. Yeah, it was.
So he tried to pick up your check?
Yeah. And at the time, she had told him, you know, look, no, you know, stop. Because he was like, pushing himself on her in the office, like everybody was watching, and it made her boss later on go up to her and go, "What was going on with him? Like, what's his problem?"
And she tells me what Gene is pulling. And but before she told me, Gene came right from there to here. So I do an interview with him. We're doing the interview. And he starts like talking about how, you know, maybe tonight I'll have sex with your girlfriend. Something. And I start laughing. I'm like, why?
Right.
Like, he's just throwing it in as a jab to me. Knowing what he knows, me not knowing what happened.
Okay.
And it was, you know, kind of serious at the time because he was, you know, being a real, like, douche about the whole thing. And like, making me look like a sap, like a douche. So Gene Simmons can kiss my ass. He's coming on our show promoting his garbage, his kiss garbage. And and meanwhile, he's personally disrespecting me.
Yep.
And the girl that I was going out with at the time, that I don't care now if he, you know, tags with the whole band. But whatever.
But at the time, it meant something.
At the time, it was like, it really pissed me off, stupid Gene. And then I brought up his dumb porno movie that he put out because he's trying so hard for attention that he's got to put out a porno. One of these, oh, someone, the tape got out. Ooh, did it? And there he is, doing the slow-mo hump. What a lousy, lousy lay.
It was bad. I didn't see it. Yeah.
Oh, horrid. Just this slow lumbering. Mix it up a little, Gene. Mix it up. God damn. He's just the one position, just same speed. The girl looked thrilled to have him on top of her. Ugh.
Yeah, especially if you're taping it, you're going to want to put on a performance.
Yeah. Do something. Yeah. Grab an ankle. Something.
You didn't say it's black and white?
No.
It's not a good movie.
No, it's awful.
You got it, then?
It's
not
horrible.
That impressive.
And you would think if Gene Simmons was going to make a movie, he'd like tie it into the kiss thing and, you know, show that he can still, you know, when he was on stage and that tongue would come out, like show a little action like that.
Just wear a kiss condom.
Something. This lumbering, slow motion, look at him. Look at him. Yeah, here I am. I'm going to get this girl. Yeah. That's what I'm doing. This is all you're going to get from Gene.
This is all she gets.
And this will cost you. Right now he's thinking of copyright infringements that are going on all over the globe. The Kiss logo.
She tried.
How could I screw over other bandmates for money?
Yeah, something went on because she went to grab his hair and quickly
moved her hand.
Moved her hand like.
Oh, of course, because it would have come off in her hand. Look, that head of hair. Stop it.
Look at this lucky girl, what she gets.
She is sexy.
That's what she's getting. Oh, God. What are they on, a bathroom rug?
No, it's a bed.
Is it?
Yeah.
That's some.
Looks like a crappy bed, too, Gene.
It's like an Afghan or something on top of the bed. Anyway. Before we,
she's got her shoes on. He's got his shoes on. What is this?
Doesn't even take his pants off.
Is he wearing socks?
I don't know.
His pants are still by his ankles.
Yeah.
You gotta like
that's
that,
good.
Though.
I'm seeing him shimmy. Go, I have to drop a turd. And just shimmy away with his pants by his ankles like an old codger. Now she's, appears to be on top. Look at him. There's
he's
no
chewing
effort.
Gum. He's chewing gum in the middle of it.
No effort
just
is he putting
on the
forth.
Gum.
For all of his sexual prowess he loves to talk about, he is just awful. God, no payoff whatsoever.
She's sexy, though, man.
How could I capitalize on a kiss lunchbox?
That is pretty bad. I mean, he's not even grabbing her at all when she's on top.
Nothing.
He's just...
Oh, God, Gene.
Just there.
All right. It's good Jimmy left because this phone call might put Anthony in a tizzy.
Why?
And it also puts Jimmy... Old Jimmy Norton in a tough position. It's Nick in Atlanta. How are you, Nick?
What's up, guys?
Hey, Nick.
Hey, every day's not complete until you have a little Gene Simmons. Old Gene is ringing the bell at NASDAQ this morning. I figured you may want to tune in, see your hero.
Oh, is that what he's doing? I saw him on the news. It was like, what? Why? What's going public, Kiss? Is that what's happening?
The Kiss stock is going public.
Wow.
It's
going
to be a great thing. I'm having an IPO for KISS.
Shut up, you fucking you money grubbing fucko.
Why do you hold a grudge?
What?
You're holding a grudge.
He personally insulted me.
Yeah.
He disrespected me.
Yeah.
In front of me, right in front of my face.
Yeah.
With knowledge that he had that I did not have at the time.
Yeah.
And was trying to make me look silly
mm-hmm.
in his eyes.
But he thought he was a Mr. Big.
Can we go to the? Can we go?
Oh,
can we go?
God.
Yeah, we did pretty well yesterday. Heidi, the Bulls showed some resilience late in the trading session, but today we're expecting
about to open
a
the market.
Lower open, and
with
the major
favorite,
averages
James
once again test their recent lows.
Look at
as
him.
One analyst says, the 400-pound gorilla in the room is the auto bailout on Capitol Hill. Yesterday, UAW Union President Ron Gettelfinger said that if one of the big three goes bankrupt, it could take the other two down with it. This comes amid more signs of distress in the housing market. New home construction plunged 4.5% last month.
He pushes the button. His wig should fly off when he hits the button. That'd be great.
Delisted from the New York Stock Exchange.
Oh, no, another
delisting. Because the share price has been under $1 for a month now.
Oops.
Well, that's all he got to do.
That's it. He presses a button so the bell rings.
Right. And then he did
the... And then he gave the fucking the rock and roll sign.
Right. Kind of a devil's...
The horns. The devil horn rock and roll sign.
The thumb out, though, too.
Why is he doing it? What does he have to do with anything? Usually the people that ring the bell have something to do with Wall Street.
Well, I'm sure he's got something going on. He's selling something. He's got shares in something.
My videotapes of my sexploits. You'll see me fuck in slow motion. So it's the only way I can fuck. Oh, please.
Why did we mention Gene Simmons?
Try your best. Oh, try your best, asshole. Whatever.
How long are you going to hold this grudge?
Forever.
Forever?
He disrespected me.
What happens if he comes in here and defends
his
position? I
will lay into him on every front, not even on the fact that he was trying to pick up my girlfriend at the time.
Do I have to remind you of what happened when you confronted Mancow? You gave him some of the best radio ever.
I gave him a great call. What a dick.
You gave him a thought starter.
I did.
And I'm sure his phones were lit with traditional radio after you hung up for another half hour.
So, but no, Gene Simmons will never be forgiven.
So you promise that there will be a nice confrontation when he finally comes in here.
I will just pummel him about his fucking sellout attitude, and then he'll just be like, I'm making money off of my company.
Yeah.
Off of Kiss. Yeah. That's what I do. That's
this stuff gets
do.
Back to Gene, you know. He called us out on something else.
Fuck
and
Gene.
And we did pretty well defending our position.
Look, there he is. They're showing a replay of him.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then he points like, yeah. Oh, it says Gene Simmons family jewels behind him. That fucking... well, reality show?
Yeah. A&E.
Stop. It's a fake reality.
But it's in
not
its like
real.
Third or fourth season. It's that
is it.
Well.
How is it doing well? Who's watching that crap?
I don't know.
Garbage. Who's buying his Kiss garbage? Grow up, people. Fucking grow up.
There's a lot of Kiss
fans
out
there. What are you
buying?
A Kiss
thing?
Shut up, stupid Kiss fans out there. You suck. You worship this fucking fossil.
Let it go, Ant.
This fucking wigged fossil.
Let it go. You made your point.
No.
You made
no.
your point.
Never let
you
it
made
go.
Your point.
He sat there in that fucking seat knowing what he attempted to do and failed miserably and then gave me shit about it.
Mm-hmm.
Like I'm sitting here like some kind of mook. Why I never. He is right. Quite a douche.
The Seth MacFarlane thing, SethComedy.com. We'll give him a nice plug today.
Fucking queen. Gene what? Simmons is a queen.
What?
He's a fucking queen.
Why is he a queen?
I'm just calling him that. Draw your own conclusions.
Now it's name calling.
Yeah.
Can we get Gene on the phone today? He's in New York.
Good one.
Maybe he could stop by. He knows where we are.
We're working on him.
Are we working on him?
Could the fuck him.
When is the conversation going down, you think?
I don't know. Whenever he fucking.
Steve? Make him some calls?
10:50.
I'll make a call right now, but that process is ongoing. The requests have been into to
course.
Get Gene in here.
Of course.
And what has he said?
Nothing yet. Nothing yet. We're waiting for a response.
He's what about
scared.
His people?
We're checking his schedule.
My
is
people.
The response you always get. Because
really?
You gotta go
I have to check with my schedule.
And call him out live on the show.
What? I call you out, Gene Simmons.
We're going to do a fight?
Show up here, and I'm going to fucking call you out first for blatant disrespect of me. And for just being a fucking whore.
Yeah.
And a queen. And a lousy fuck. As proved on his lousy fuck videotape. What? Called, I'm Gene Simmons, a lousy fuck.
What would it take for to get to fisticuffs?
Might come to blows.
Yeah?
Could come to blows.
Are we fighting after school today?
I'd pop him. Oh, if I popped him in the face, a lawyer would pop out his asshole and serve me with a subpoena in a second. Well, that's my asshole lawyer, and you are now sued.
What if he said no lawyers?
Do what you have to. What,
fist man to man?
Yeah.
With fists?
Yeah.
Will he get to wear his big, tall shoes?
Yeah.
So he looks bigger than the short little Jew he is?
Is he really short, you think?
He's Jewish. I don't know if he's short.
There's some tall
Jews. He's been in here. I think he's...
What's some of those tall Jews?
Jeff Goldblum.
Which leads to what we want to play for everybody. That's called a segue in the biz, people.
And Danny just look at each other.
It's the only one. And I must say, on instant feedback, they're kind of getting the chills of the douche variety because they know how this is going to end.
How?
With maybe a back down on your part.
Nope. Ain't going to back down. I will leave the situation before I back down. If he won't, because he always just keeps talking, you know, or he'll put his hand over the keyboard while Danny's trying to type, because what he's saying is so fucking important that hearing a clickety-clack over it just ruins it. What the fuck is that idiot saying that's so important that a clickety-clack of a keyboard, of a new keyboard, they barely make a noise?
And I was trying upset. To be extra quiet.
Yeah. He was upset, Danny, because you aren't paying attention to him.
Yeah.
Because he's in the room and someone wasn't paying attention to him in the room.
I got to say, Danny backed down as well. I'm disappointed
no,
in Danny
I didn't,
as well.
No, you know what?
You should have been like, clang, clang, clang.
Oh, I just started hitting him with a mallet. I'd have played whack-a-key.
Right.
With a fucking mallet.
It's not my show.
Well,
we should bring that's the only reason I didn't get up in his face a little more
you.
Than that.
Next time he comes in, we're going to have a xylophone for you.
Dude, I swear, I have an old keyboard from the 80s that's just covered in filth, and it's so loud and terrible. Like, you can't even pretend to be quiet on it, because the minute you apply pressure, it just click, clack.
I like
click,
the xylophone clack. Idea, though.
You just start playing it. Just coming with a mallet. Xylophone. Oh, would that be great?
All right, well... Frankenstein was a tall Jew. Thank you, Pat from Wenatchee.
Same guy, him and Gene. Just pull the wig off, Gene.
You know,
I'm Frankenstein.
Yeah. What exactly did Gene do? People don't know yet?
Carl. What are you, insane?
Carl.
I was locked up around the beginning of Jill and Nicolini. I mean, and Nicolini, I'm guessing it's got to do with that, but I just got out. And I don't know what's going on, so I'm trying to get caught up.
All right, hold on.
What are you locked up for?
Yeah, we want to be caught up with you. You got locked up for what?
Well, it was a bunch of outstanding parking tickets and warrants, and then I beat up a cop.
Wow. We got a lot of cop friends. They're not happy to hear this today, Carl.
No. I love the cops. I really do. But this guy was one of those a shirt two sizes too small, mirrored sunglasses, talk to the judge. And I just really had enough of him.
Well, you can't hit them.
Yeah, you can't hit a cop. That might be a bad thing.
I didn't mean to.
All right. So how much time did you do?
Are you calling from a Matrix phone? It's like, this sounds like the Matrix.
It's a piece of crap public internet phone.
All right. How much time did you do for beating up the cop and the parking tickets?
After all was said and done, and my lawyers and my money, it was probably about 5.5 months.
Oy. What was the worst thing that happened to you in the joint?
Nothing. It's bullshit in there. There's nothing.
You got raped in the ass, didn't you?
All right, yes.
It's not gay if you're in jail. You know that, right?
Yeah, of course not.
All right.
Thank you.
Hey, Carl, so, well, you need to know what happened.
Gene Simmons went over to the news over there. What is it called? The CW 11 News, where Jill Nicolini was doing the traffic at the time, and pretty much pinned her against the wall and started coming on to her. So why don't we go out tonight?
Mm-hmm.
Me and you. Let's go out. We'll go out. And other people in the room were very uncomfortable with the way he was coming on to her like that. Because he was being overly aggressive, almost like a rape. So then she says, no, I got a boyfriend. And then he was like, I don't care. Whatever. And then she goes, by the way, you're going over there to see him in a few minutes. When you leave here, you're doing his radio show. It's Anthony from the Opie and Anthony show. I don't care. Doesn't matter to me. Whatever. So he finally backs off, puts his
shitty working fucking shit fucking dick away and came over here, sat down in that very chair, and said to me that maybe I'll fuck your girlfriend tonight.
Which was like ha ha.
And it was like a ha ha thing.
But it was based on some stuff.
And then I started laughing like, well, you know, I said if you only knew who she was, and he didn't fess up that he did know. He didn't fess up about his like just fucking the way he was coming on like that. So he disrespected me by saying that.
Mm-hmm.
And by pulling that crap even after he knew that she had a boyfriend and it was me and whatever. Now, like I said, I don't give a shit because, you know, that relationship's ancient history.
But it's
a friend.
Man thing.
It's a thing that transcends the relationship. It becomes an issue of two men being in a room and him being a fucking asshole and being disrespectful to me. And I'm not going to fucking have him come on here and hawk his wares and sell his Kiss garbage and use this as a platform to make even more money off of those rubes that fucking buy his shit. What the fuck?
He's still talking about Gene Simmons.
Yeah.
Okay.
It doesn't matter now, but I really wonder why Jill didn't give you a heads up when he was on the way here.
She told me the fact because she didn't want a big deal made of it.
Oh.
She didn't want a big deal made of it.
Yeah, I understand why. She didn't want to disrupt the show and be like the chick who gets people in trouble.
Right. So she didn't want to make a big deal of it.
Yeah. She didn't want to give us good radio. Yeah,
but
I understand.
But now...
It would have been an amazing radio.
I think she gave
I think she pretty much was a trooper with giving
good
radio.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, I gotta say.
And most people
good point,
don't.
Good point.
People don't think in life that'll be good radio.
Yeah, yeah.
No one thinks that really. Like,
in real life, yeah.
All right. So how does this end with the confrontation?
Gene Simmons sitting there at some point.
Uh-huh.
He will sit there. I will explain that situation as I just did.
Yelling and he will, or calmly?
Calmly, but with barbs. I will inject some barbs into him as I'm doing it.
Yep.
Because he won't let me fucking talk anyway.
Right.
He'll be talking and then he'll just add, wait. Why so upset, Anthony?
Yeah.
Anthony, his condescending, passive-aggressive shit.
Yeah. Can we have the official Anthony's calling out Gene Simmons promo for this fine channel of ours?
Of course.
The official Anthony has called you out, Gene. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely.
We want the official promo, and I want to hear it sooner than later.
Gene Simmons, you're a lousy fuck. You're disrespectful, and I fucking call you out.
Oh!
Yes. Yes.
No, he didn't. That might be a little too harsh. You might have to call somebody out a little different so they're willing to come to the table. See, I wouldn't be willing to come to the table if I heard of that.
I'd be like, you better come to the table.
I wouldn't.
You better come to the table.
Oh, shit.
That's it.
Could it end in a fake fight like you have to be held back?
Oh, it's like
you're trying to get
let me at him.
But they're holding you back.
It should end like one of the old Monday night wrestling shows where it's just like the big climax is happening, but they're running out of time. They got to go.
No, we're out of time, King. And then it just cuts off.
Yeah, Sam runs in with the steel chair and it just fades to black.
You remember that shit? It used to just stop.
Yeah.
There'd be a giant fight going on and they'd be like, well, we're going to wrap this slobber knocker up.
And you come out Monday and it's never referenced again.
No. What the fuck?
We've had great confrontations over the years. Let's not forget the Mancow confrontation, the Whoopi Goldberg confrontation. That was just an
Gene
amazing
Gene Simmons
one.
Has to try to hit on fucking other guys' chicks because that's the only in he has with girls. He talks about his fucking prowess. From what I saw in that videotape, he couldn't fucking, he can't fuck. He's awful.
I think the promo's too harsh. I'll redo it for you real quick.
All right. Go ahead.
Anthony Cumia needs to talk to Gene Simmons. This is Jim Norton. Big fan, Gene. Love the old stuff.
Boy. No,
and
no,
Anthony
no,
wants
no,
to
no.
talk to Gene about something.
No.
I'm a big...
No.
What's wrong with that?
Love the old stuff.
What's wrong with that?
I think it was too nice.
All right.
Like, then he might feel like he's blindsided when he comes in.
You know what? You're right.
Yeah.
We're working on the calling out Gene Simmons official promo. Just do something with the wig. The wig.
Gene, I call you out. Come on this show, and I'll rip your fucking wig off.
Oh! Too harsh.
Too harsh?
Too harsh. No one will come on the show to have their wig taken off. Who would? I wouldn't.
Damn it.
We'll see what kind of balls he
has. How about this?
Yeah. Not too good. Big droopy ones from watching that fucking porno. Shit. That horrid porno that he made to try to fucking get a little heat. Mm-hmm. What happened there, Gene? What happened there, Gene? Didn't pan out for you, that fucking porno? Ugh. Learn how to fuck and then tape it. Maybe you should tape a few and preview it.
What's the sounds of Gene Simmons having sex again?
What? Boom, 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 boom. I'm fucking a girl. I'm a fucking. I'm Gene Simmons. I'm a fucking. Could you fuck me faster, Gene? No, no, no. Look at him. Look at him. Fucking plastic face wig head. It says kiss at the New York Stock Exchange. Yeah, no, yeah. It's just Gene Simmons. Look at him. What the fuck is he pointing at?
I just want to say.
What is this idiot saying? Please, I got
to
hear it.
Trying to get the audio in.
Get the audio. I want to hear what this complete fucking asshole is saying.
He was calling you out.
Yes, I call you out. Oh.
Do we have enough audio for the calling out promo?
Look at that fucking G.I. Joe hair. It's fake.
Do you need calling out promo audio?
Yeah.
All right. Gene Simmons, this is Jim Norton. Had a great time at the roast. Anthony is calling you out. He takes umbrance at what you've said.
Umbrance?
Is that not a word?
I thought it was umbrage.
Oh.
I'll take some umbrance,
too. That's right. It's hot in here. He likes some umbrance and a little umbrage.
Umbrage. Oh, come on. Hey. Gene Simmons, star of A&E reality show Family Jewels.
That's right, Ann.
There's Paul. And there's Ace.
Hey, Ann, know what I'm getting for Christmas? The Gene Simmons Guitar Hero guitar.
Oh, wow. He actually was able to finagle his fucking way into that, huh?
Yeah. Looks good, though.
Oh, it's the axe guitar?
Yeah.
Looks like a big battle axe?
Yeah, you can get that for Guitar Hero,
Gene,
man.
Gene is so cool.
Who wouldn't want this? You're just jealous.
Ugh. I smell Gene's fucking last album. What is that?
Oh, my God.
Oh, Jimmy farted?
I get sad when
I bet the underside of Gene's wig smells like that. That's what it smells like. Oh, God, that's horrible. Wow, is that bad.
Oh, boy, here we go. Borskin is not happy. Borskin, what's going on?
Hey, and hey. Don't you know Gene can kick your ass, man? You know how good a shape you got to be in to go on tour and be around all like that?
Fuck that. I saw the video of him fucking. He sucks. If you can't fuck, you can't fight.
Fuck him or fight him.
We're getting some advice here for you, Ant. We got Kevin the trucker. Kevin.
Hey, good evening.
Good evening.
Guys, Ed, here's the thing. Because he's so passive-aggressive, and I'm on your side about this,
yeah.
You know he's going to come at you with that whole, well, I've obviously affected you. You'll have no effect on me
yeah.
kind of attitude. I just want to know what your response to that would be.
I'll say, shut up.
Wow, that's...
All right.
That's scary.
All right.
That's kind
of
scary.
No, I'll say, I'm not going to play your stupid passive-aggressive game where you sit there all calm and just talk it out and then make, like, because I'm angry that I'm the wrong one or the crazy one here. You're a douche.
Mm-hmm.
You're fucking... You sold out your band, your institution, your bandmates. Everyone knows. Everyone calls you a douchebag. Behind your back or to your face. I'm just doing it to your face. Most people do it behind your back. I'll just throw shit in like that. I go, everyone knows you're a fucking money-grubbing asshole who would sell his own mother for a fucking buck. Because that's what you do. You took the rest of the guys in the band who were key players when Kiss was at its peak years ago and just sold them all down the fucking river. And you keep the franchise going because that's all you got.
Damn.
Because obviously you can't fuck and sell porno tapes.
It's got to end with the wig being removed.
And then take the wig! Ooh. Linger longer.
I like that. Take the wig.
Yeah. Lingy longy.
Lingy longy.
Lingy longy.
That's the promo you guys want.
Oh, here we go. Fred from Brooklyn. He's good for one.
Hi, Fred!
Hello, Fred.
Hey. Congrats, Opie.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Hey, you better have some of New York's finest standing by. Gene blows fire. Watch it, Ant.
That's Watch true. It. What if he is a demon? He blows fire.
What if he breathes some of that fire on you?
Ted fire.
Then what?
Ted fire.
What if he breathes that fire on you?
I'll dodge it.
Yeah?
Yeah. He's blowing fire. I'm dodging it.
You're gonna back out, aren't you?
No, why would I? Why would I?
I think you back out.
Nope. This is a man to man issue. Mm-hmm. He disrespected me. Mm-hmm. As a man, mm-hmm. He disrespected me, which is the worst thing you can do. Not as a performer, he didn't disrespect me, which I don't care, or anything like that. No opinion on this, that, the other thing. He disrespected me.
All right, let's go.
He knew the deal, yet he sat in that fucking chair and gave me what of it, thinking that he wasn't going to say anything because that night, you know, they were going to go out.
Yeah,
he still had it in his head that, you know, we'll go out. Could we go out?
Can we get Jill on the phone? To
no, she never get on the phone. She hates me.
Nate in Brooklyn. Nate, how are you?
Hey, guys.
Hey, Nate.
I just wanted to know, is Ant going to be every bit as harsh on Gene as he was on Sarah Jessica Parker and Bill Donahue?
Oh, more of our confrontations.
They never disrespected
We've
me.
We've had a few
One got me fired, but...
Well, we're getting some advice for your fight. Dale in Minnesota. Dale.
Anthony.
Yeah?
What you got to do is just, before you guys get into it, throw some pennies on the board to distract them.
Fucking Dale.
Punch it out.
All righty. Throw some pennies on the floor. Right. Apparently that will slow them down.
Let's go up to Queensbury and say
where?
Hi to Matt. Queensbury.
Hey, guys. What's up?
Hi, Matt.
Matt of the Queensbury. Yes.
Ant, I have a question for you, Ant.
Yes, sir.
Who are you going to root for in a fight to the death between Gene Simmons and Barack Obama?
Ooh, good question.
I'd have to go with Barack. He's younger. He's in better shape because he goes to the gym and whatnot. And you never bet on the white guy in a fight.
You know,
for
the
most part. Wow, you must hate Gene.
Unless you're that.
Keith in San Francisco.
Hey, guys.
Hey, faggot.
What's up, Keith?
I got a question for you. What if he gives you the condescending, well, then I'm sorry that it happened?
Yeah, what if there's an apology?
If there's an apology? No, yeah. I don't accept an apology.
Nice.
Because he could have done that.
I like that.
That day.
That's
No, and it wouldn't be sincere. He'd never apologize. He didn't apologize to his bandmates.
Hey, you know, I don't think we've ever played the actual clip of him saying, maybe I'll fuck your girlfriend tonight.
Ooh, wow.
Can we find that?
Find Gene's tape and see what he actually said.
All right.
Because maybe I was wrong. Maybe we got off on the wrong foot.
Maybe. Maybe it's a big misunderstanding.
Oh. Okay,
he is Dr. Love.
No, he's not. He needs a doctor to make fucking love. Inject some adrenaline into that motherfucker. The slow motion fucking asshole.
How does this song make you feel, like? Seriously. Don't hold back.
It's a pretty rockin' tune.
It sure is.
You know, how old is it? How old is this song? 1977.
31 years.
All right.
Yeah.
See? Enough said.
Yeah. Yeah?
There's like three Kiss songs I can tolerate.
Say you like Beth, because he hates Beth.
Listen to this. What's that voice?
It's awful.
I love it.
Looking back, it's awful. I love this growing up, too, but come on.
Do they?
Yeah.
Yeah? I'm fucking suing you for malpractice then, Dr. Love, because you stink.
All right, Greg in
New
Hampshire.
The doctor is out.
Greg.
Hey, boys. Just calling to say quality SiriusXM broadcast today. Worth every penny. And Gregory, have a very nice weekend, sir.
Thank you, sir. All the well wishes are greatly appreciated, by the way. See, I'm not that much of an asshole.
They call me Dr. Wig.
It warms my heart. All right, so we'll get the Gene Simmons conversation happening. It'll end in fist fight, hopefully.
Whatever.
Or fake you're getting held back fist fight.
It's going to look like the hat removal fucking video when his hair goes flying.
Oh, my God. How funny would that
Comes
be?
Comes in with his fucking walker.
How funny would that be?
Oh, smash him.
We finally got the Gene Simmons clip that Anthony has been referring to.
Yeah.
You have officially called out Gene Simmons. We
yes.
got the official Anthony calls out Gene Simmons promo that will be on the channel shortly, hopefully.
Yeah.
And we'll see how this ends.
Yes.
And you swear you're not going to back down.
Ow.
You do know he's the God of Thunder, though.
I care less the God of
how
Thunder.
How do you fight the God of Thunder, my friend? Explain that one.
I'll shut him down. Don't yeah? you don't you worry about
but he's
it.
He's the God.
The God of Thunder was just on the MS or CNBC looking like a douche.
Right.
Looking like an asshole.
Yeah.
Entrepreneur. Gene Simmons. No, it's Kiss sellout guy.
Yeah.
What has he done? What has he done that didn't involve just selling that fucking, squeezing every dime he could out of that Kiss name? How is that an entrepreneur? You put the fucking the logo on a lunchbox? You make a Kiss coffin, Kiss credit cards. That's being an entrepreneur. That's being a whore.
Look at this, Ant.
Yeah.
Just a little, because you don't have, look over here, just over here.
Shit.
Just showing you top secret stuff.
I can't see that.
Well, keep bending over.
What is it? I can't see it.
Hold on.
I like secrets.
Hold on.
Don't tell no secrets. Keep it to yourself.
Wait.
I'm going to write it for you.
What's going on? What's the secret?
Pop him in the shitter while he's bent over like that.
I couldn't read it.
All right, bend over again.
I don't want to be popped in the shitter.
No, here's what you got to do. I'm going to show you a game. It's called Hide the Eel in the Cave.
Yeah. I don't know. Hold on. This one is. Hold on.
Do some push-ups in there.
This is just same old shit. Just a different year. Fuck you. All right, so we got the original.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
Like how?
I don't know.
To hear how.
Yeah.
Well. What happened?
I can't say, Jimmy.
I like secrets. Is it about me?
Well, yeah.
No.
You got us. Gene Simmons, this is what how it went down originally. In. Right. So people could be up to speed. Maybe we could add this to the official Anthony calling out Gene Simmons promo. All right?
Yes.
This is the original comment.
What do you do for pleasure?
I intend on fucking your girlfriend tonight. I don't know.
Hey.
Whoa, hey.
Wait a minute now.
Well, I mean that as a term of endearment.
You actually probably just met her over at Channel 11.
Who? Oh, Jill.
Yes.
Yes. No, I'm fucking with you. But the point I'm making... The point I'm making...
All of a sudden he looked at me with a little more respect. I like that.
I'm not at all concerned with respect. I really am not.
Apparently not.
Wow, that's the original thing.
That bastard.
It sounded like you guys were getting along to me.
See, because he knew, and I didn't, so I was just like, ah, ha, ha, ha.
Mm.
You know. Oh. You see how he sounded like that? He knew.
Mm. All right.
Gene.
We'll wait for the next chapter.
Go blow.
The Gene Simmons official promos. Wow.
Oh, look how fast.
Anthony, now you got the official.
The official challenge.
Calling out Gene Simmons promo.
Challenge.
Gene Simmons, you're a lousy fuck. You're disrespectful, and I fucking call you out.
Gene Simmons has to try to hit on fucking other guys' chicks.
I'll be fucking your girlfriend because that's the only in he has with girls. He talks about his fucking prowess. From what I saw in that videotape, he can't fuck. Gene, I call you out. Come on this show, and I'll rip your fucking wig off. Gene Simmons is a fucking cunt. Wow.
Jimmy's
no,
crying.
The guy fucking
knew, and
he was bullshitting and trying to play me like a fucking sap as I sat here.
I'll be fucking your girlfriend.
I'm fucking a girl.
Not knowing what happened yet.
I'm a fucking... I'm Gene Simmons.
Cocksucker. Fuck you.
I think the promo's too harsh. I'll redo it for you real quick.
All right. Anthony!
Anthony Cumia needs to talk to Gene Simmons. This is Jim Norton, big fan, Gene. Love the old stuff.
Boy, no.
And Anthony wants to talk to Gene about something.
What's wrong with that? Gene Simmons, I fucking call you out.
Nice.
Wow.
Solid.
That's some power.
Not enough for me.
We got the official promo. Nice. Game on, Ant.
Game on.
Fighting after school.
Fuck that guy.
Jeff. And also, I got to be honest. I know this is a very sore subject with Ant, but...
Oh, no.
Gene Simmons has a point.
With the watch.
Kiss unhappy about Rock and Roll Hall of Fame exclusion.
Screw them. They're a gimmick. They're a gimmick band.
They stole New York Dolls Act.
No, they didn't.
They're a gimmick band. Why not put the Monkees in there then? Same thing, gimmick band. Why, what is he upset with?
Just that they're not in like
that. I can't put it on my products. I can't put that Kiss Rock and Roll Hall of Fame winners on my products. It's keeping food out of my children's mouths. It's keeping wigs off of my head.
There's...
He doesn't even care about the food out of his kid's mouth.
He doesn't care. They can just cook it in that wok he wears on his head. Here it is. They've sold millions of records. They've influenced... Gene Simmons wants to know why they're not in. He's like, there are disco bands, rap bands, Yiddish folk song bands, but not Kiss. And I believe we have more gold records in America than any other group.
Is it about record sales? Is that what the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame is about? Record sales? Excuse me. Didn't the Archies sell a lot of records? Why aren't the Archies in there? Because I think Ron Bennington said that. If you let Kiss in, you got to let the Archies in.
Well, they let Madonna, first ballot Hall of Fame, the Grandmaster Flash. So they've obviously
I don't agree
with
a lot of things, but because I don't agree with a lot of inductions doesn't mean I would say that Kiss belongs in there. Gimmick, paint their face up.
I want to rock and roll all night.
Children's band. It's a child's band. They dress like it on Halloween. Little kids paint their face up for Halloween like Kiss. Stop it. Gene. Oh, look, Gene's on Channel 5. Oh, wait. No, that's Rabbi Shalom Patlal. He's just...
What are you doing?
Apparently nothing.
Can I ask not to be
a dick? Yeah,
I have it here.
Yeah, Iraq.
All right, but why wouldn't you play it?
Why wouldn't you just start playing some, especially maybe the song Jimmy was singing, like a popular Kiss song, just in the background low. Yeah, now, doing it now just defeats the purpose. Don't do it now and say, okay, there. Please explain why you didn't just spark that up.
Like, I started talking about Kiss in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and we talked about it for a couple of minutes.
I was also loading up another Kiss song that we frequent on this show.
Another Kiss? For what? How about launching the first one?
The first one's right here.
No. I'm not saying do it now. I'm not saying do it now. The moment is gone. You missed it. I'm just wondering why you missed it. Why didn't you play it?
I've never understood Opie more than I do today.
Yes.
Ope, if you're listening, I get it.
Now it's like it's starting to kind of sink in. You're like, he's an idiot.
Yeah.
Why didn't you play it?
I was getting the other song.
Why get the other song?
Because that's the one we usually go to when we do Kiss.
But any Kiss song is good.
But there was no Pavarotti this morning. There was no Kiss. E-Rock, I'm a big defender of yours. But today, you've missed a lot of cues. As a matter of fact, there has not been one iota of music.
No!
Not that we need a music bed.
There was the wedding music, like 20 minutes into our wedding discussion.
There was no Pavarotti. There was no gospel.
No gospel, right.
I feel like I'm doing college radio. I'm getting out of here.
Yeah, exactly.
How would you know anything about a college?
I don't... Don't overact with your hands, all right?
No one saw it. They just heard the well-delivered line.
Your eyes pop out like you're at an audition.
So do your teeth.
I know.
Here, Rock, why is there no teeth popping out music?
You don't think they took a little of New York Dolls, Jack Kiss?
I don't know anything about New York Dolls.
I hate the New York Dolls. Exactly. I don't know anything about these people.
Who are they, Pop Pop? I don't know who they are. Shut your face, stupid. No one's talking about the New York Dolls. They stole from Al Jolson, who put on makeup. All right, we got it. They didn't.
Pop, pop.
Stalker. So bad he's saying a Kiss album is better than
it. I know, which is...
Kiss Alive is a great live album.
They're horrible, Jimmy.
No, they're not.
Kiss
couldn't say the Who live
could
at Leeds.
Be one of the worst bands
ever.
Ever.
Who? The Who?
No, Kiss. Oh. Sorry. I went to...
Wanna rock and roll.
I went to the Kiss show. Remember that? At NEW? Yeah, we went to Kiss. And I was like, after it was over, I realized how few real hits they had. Because they played them all, and it was like three.
Yeah, they didn't have a tremendous amount. Beth, I think, was the biggest song they ever had.
I want to rock and roll. That
was a big hit, yeah.
And then,
but
like,
Gene even
that,
had to take credit for Beth, remember?
No, I know.
Could even give Peter Criss a little spotlight. He goes,
Gene's
well,
a fucking
actually,
douche.
Peter Criss came up with the song Sarah, and I told him, Sarah, we'll sing the same song, but say Beth.
Say Beth.
Or whatever. What was the original name of that song?
So then I took him for all his money.
Right.
Because that's what I do.
Then I kicked him out of the band because he wouldn't play the way I wanted him to.
Yeah.
Parasite's a great fucking Kiss song.
That's your favorite band is Kiss?
No.
Besides Ozzy?
Sabbath is my favorite band. I like Kiss a lot. Kiss is more... They have a
nostalgia. It's basically,
for me.
If you were a girl a 12 years ago, you would have liked the Spice Girls.
It's
that's
a joke
basically
band.
Like,
yes.
No, I,
without their fucking makeup. Costumes, they're a bad garage
Look,
band.
There's the one guy with the big shoes and the tongue. And
they were
fake
the
blood,
fucking
and fire.
What is that?
Yeah, it was.
What a douche chill.
And plus,
was.
Like I said before,
Paul Stanley's the star child.
What was the 70s?
What does that mean? Douchey. Fuck it. Ugh.
Look, marketing wise, you have to say.
They knew how to market.
They were fucking very good marketers.
They stole. I told you they stole.
If you say New York Dolls,
they stole New York Dolls. They did it.
New
York Dolls were doing that shit before them, dressing up like transvestites. You should love them.
Kiss. It's the Kiss coffin.
Yeah.
Just pouring themselves
out. Fucking Gene's marketing of everything. I have the Kiss credit card now.
Hawk, I got
to
defend one.
You could charge your Kiss merchandise.
How can we make money off of them when they're dead?
Yeah.
One point at a time.
Still make money.
Kiss visits
Tupac.
You know,
if you make some decent my favorite albums, band. You wouldn't have to sell fucking car keys at the end of your fucking show.
Kiss sold. They sold 100 million albums.
Tractor trailers full of shit. It's the Kiss can opener.
They sell the most shit.
Dude,
Kiss, unapologetically.
They sold 100 million albums. You can't not Kiss.
Toothbrush.
They sold 100
their
million
Their catalog
albums.
Is as big as the phone book of stuff you could buy.
Tremendously successful.
Don't fuck it.
It's like Madonna. Already. If you could write a good song, you could keep your fucking clothes on.
I'm with Bill, by the way.
I think she wants to do all that yoga.
I'm with Bill. Live at Leeds is an amazing live album.
Who's that by?
The Who.
The Who.
I saw them twice
in
concert.
I don't like The Who. Though.
I had them
play a row. I don't hate The Who. They're just overrated.
No, you don't like The Who.
Who? They were very overrated.
How
Quadrophenia.
Do you say The Who was overrated, but Kiss wasn't?
Because Kiss is not judged the way The Who is in rock standards. Look, we all know Kiss, lyrically, was not up to par with a lot of bands. Musically, they're not up to... I mean, like, it's just...
So
just
why
I
are
like,
they a band? what a good wiffle ball player.
I know.
I'll tell you what I like about them.
I mean, musically, they were a little overrated. Yes. But, you know.
But not like that. Kiss is not known for that. They were just known as a
but
whole
you can't,
show.
You can't say The Who
was
overrated, though. The Who was a monster band.
So what? I still think they were overrated.
Oh, my God. How were they overrated back then?
Because they're heralded as this amazing band. The way the Rolling Stone writes about them, the way they diss Sabbath for all those years, and they make The Who look like they were these amazing... Or Zeppelin. Oh, they were these amazing... And then they fucking stole this shit. I'm talking about Zeppelin. Fuck them. The Who was a good band. I'm not saying Moon wasn't a great drummer. Dolph Street's a great singer, and fucking Townsend was good. But they were just overrated as a unit because they were fucking comfortable for fucking rock writers. That's who they liked.
Well,
so that's
no,
who they
came
like, R.E.M.
out. Quadrophenia was fucking brilliant.
Was that the rock opera? Fucking eat my asshole.
No, that was Tommy.
Fucking rock opera.
That was Tommy.
The first time that I met you, I shut it.
No, that was Tommy.
What about Who's Next?
But it was creative.
Jimmy
it was fucking
creative. Oh, Jimmy doesn't know any better.
Who's in the title? I get it. Who are you? That's us.
Who? Who?
What?
If I hear you call.
This coming in, Jimmy has the musical taste of a five-year-old.
I like fucking...
if the band doesn't have a lunchbox, Jimmy doesn't like them.
I gotta tell you, Jimmy, to say the Who's overrated is a rough one.
You got your,
that's a rough one. That's what you believe. That's fine, but that's a rough one.
And then Kiss, and then the Partridge Family.
Then the Jonas Brothers.
I don't judge Kiss on the same level as Sabbath, and I don't. I wouldn't give them music with the. I just like them. They were from my childhood, so I like them. You know.
Fucking!
Oh my God! What are some of those other Who songs that we all enjoyed? Behind Blue Eyes,
Pinball Wizard,
Pinball Wizard.
I'm not saying the Who sucks.
Trip Kid.
Yeah,
I like that one. That's like one of my favorite.
Eminence Front when they were getting a little older.
Yeah. Bam, bam, bam.
I even like that one.
Under the Raging Moon. Bam, bam. Under the Raging Moon.
It's such a genius thing. I mean, it's like literally like three notes, and he found it.
Mm. And it was Roger Daltrey actually playing the guitar in that one. If you remember the video, and he's like. That's all he could play was bam, bam, bam.
Can we hear that?
And the whole song is just bam, 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 bam.
Let's hear the amazing Who on Eminem's front.
The song they did for Under the Raging Moon that they did for Keith Moon when he died was fucking great. They had like all these drummers on it. You know what I'm saying?
How about Roger Daltrey, Free Me? Let's not forget about that one.
Right. Yeah. What about Pete Townsend had some solo stuff.
Yes, it was called fucking kitty porn.
Rough Boys.
Rough Young Boys.
Townsend, right? That was one of Pete Townsend's songs.
That wasn't bad until he got busted doing research.
Yeah. That's like, oh, I can't listen to Rough Boys anymore.
And they brought some synthesizers in.
Oh, this is terrific.
Yeah, but this wouldn't be the first song I played to a brand new Who fan.
This one was this when this great. Came out.
No,
though,
I said this was later on in their like career, and it was all right.
Yeah. The chase scene, the fucking Shaft movie.
Post Keith Moon.
Yeah, they were already at it for about 15 years when this thing came out.
And listen, when
this is
kicks
terrific
in.
Stuff.
Nah, this is just a prelude. Come on, that's fucking cool
shit.
Riff.
This sucks as shit.
You know?
I mean, they're not spitting blood, Jimmy. But
I'm not comparing them to Kiss.
There's no
I'm not saying they're better
tall
than
shoes.
I wouldn't argue that point. But Sabbath, I would argue.
I do like Gene Simmons shoes, though. Yeah, where do I get a pair of them?
7-inch heels. I put them on. I was 4'7". I didn't spit blood because my wig caught on fire. The star child and the devil wig man. I have Emilio Estevez's wig on.
Corey has something on Kiss that I'm not really sure if this is true. Let's
Hi,
see.
Corey.
Let's see what this is about. Corey, go ahead.
Corey, caller.
Good morning, boys.
Morning.
Corey.
Hey, I saw...
Good evening.
What, Corey? Corey, start over. We were goofing over the first part of your call.
I apologize.
Go ahead.
I saw an interview with Gene Simmons where they talked about the fact that the Kiss Alive album was not a live album.
Why was it just... What did it have, fucking...
fake applause?
Yeah, did it have stuff like that mixed into the background?
To punch it up a little?
No. If the vocals couldn't be done, I guess they're... I don't want to say they stopped.
Baby.
I have a follow-up question.
He's all like distracted by his kid.
Yeah, this is hopefully so.
We'll try to get info on that. Let's say hi to Jim in Staten Island.
Hey, yo.
Yeah, I was wondering, guys. Listen, I figured you would like this because a lot of this song's about like drinking and underage girls. I mean, what's the big deal?
It's so fucking phony. Just stop. Yeah. Underage girls. Look at Paul Stanley and tell me he was ever into girls.
Love Gun.
You know,
I was Lisa loving you.
When I was growing up,
you're not making a good argument, sir. I'm not a Kiss fan.
When I was growing up, I liked Kiss like Jimmy did, and then I kind of grew out of it when I learned about Zeppelin.
Yeah,
believe it or not, Jethro Tull. I don't know why. Black Sabbath.
Jethro Tull.
And then Kiss
the
was like to me, I was done with them. If you're gonna watch reality shows, you're gonna want to watch the Octomom being a horrendous mom and a lunatic.
I hear she's
not this sort of like stage reality that we're all heading toward.
I hear she's kind of crazy from everything in the news and her interviews. Crazy. Does that make a reality show?
Yes.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
I mean, is she crazy all the time, or is it going to have to be written in craziness like they do with fucking shows that just don't have enough shit going on in them?
Just to having the cameras rolling as the kids are just wandering around the house unsupervised.
I got to give it to Ozzy and the Osbournes. That show. It had crazy enough shit just based on its own to make it entertaining. I look at commercials for... I've never tuned in and never will, but the commercials for fucking Gene Simmons Family Jewels. I can't even look at the commercial without getting a douchey chill.
Why?
Because he's so fucking fake. The whole thing's phony. Ugh. It's just a fake reality show. It's not real. I want reality. Yeah, believe me, I'm not happy with Ozzy and his stupid commercials that he's doing every...
The commercials are lame, Jimmy.
They're bad, but I don't care.
It's all bad.
Ozzy's getting some fucking dough. Good for him. He should be doing commercials.
Some do-re-mi.
That's right.
Whatever Ozzy does. Ozzy was the dark horse long enough. He was the fucking, you know what I mean? He was the problem long enough. The fact that he's doing a little commercial shit when he's almost 60, I let him have fun.
Yeah.
Good for Oz. He fucking bit the head off of two animals, caught shit from the Catholic Church. He got kicked out of Texas for pissing on the Alamo, tried to choke his wife. What do people want from this fucking guy? He's done everything a rock star should do. He's almost died 300 times. Fucking does nothing but throw up on himself, forgets the words to his own songs. Guys, he changed his television by doing a reality show, and he makes a few bucks singing Take Me Out to the Ball Game and doing a few things. Everybody wants to fucking kick him in his uncircumcised dick. Leave Ozzy alone.
You have some valid points there, James.
The guy has been the fucking dark horse in music. All he is, the other rockers would look at him in awe at what a fuck up he was. So I'm all for it.
All right.
You win the argument.
Gene Simmons I had a weird run in with, but afterwards it all works out. But I've heard Gretzky's great.
I met Gene Simmons once at the Golden Apple in Los Angeles, and he was nice enough, but man, I've never met anybody who was more into making money.
Oh my God!
I thought I liked making money, but I'm a nickel and dime artist. This guy,
he's a machine.
Oh my God! The dude, like, literally, we were just introduced by Bill Leibowitz, this dude who used to run Golden Apple, who died, and he within no lie, dude, within 3 minutes, the dude had whipped out a notepad and showed me all these projects he was working on,
Jesus Christ.
And then he showed me, he's like, "But you know what's really going to make me rich?" And I was like, "No, tell me. I assumed you were." And he flips the page. I mean, you're fucking Gene Simmons. He flipped a page, and there was a picture of a dollar sign. And I was like, I didn't know what he was trying to say. Like, I was like, "That's going to make you rich? Yeah, money? Well, is this a game of some sort? What kind of game is being played?" He then proceeded to tell me that he had trademarked the dollar sign on a bag.
On a bag, like in Monopoly.
Yes.
That...
And then he was my Parker Brothers, whoever makes that game, was eventually going to owe him money.
I was like,
dude, we just met.
Yeah, why are you telling me this?
Why are you telling me your harebrained scheme?
When he said, "I'm going to show you how to make money," did you think he was going to take his wig off and cook vegetables in it and say, "The wok"?
The Gene Simmons wok. That's what it is.
Well, you want to go home, don't you, Kevin? I heard you just want
to
stop by for
had a lot
hour.
Of sex, didn't he?
Oh, it's all that was fucking
apparently.
He didn't smoke, didn't drink. He never fucked
did
around.
You ever hear that NPR interview he did?
No.
Really?
No.
Not a good one.
It's spellbinding. He gets on with Terry Gross Fresh Air or something like that. And he's the most hostile, standoffish fucking
Gene
guest, on the planet. Where he's just and he keeps coming at her for being an NPR broadcaster. He's like, "Well, you know, I don't know if that's how they do it here. It's NPR, you know, coming
he's
like
a conservative guy. He's much more conservative guy. Like when you talk about the Middle East, and he probably NPR has a very liberal reputation. Mm-hmm. He probably was annoyed about that. That's my guess.
And at one point, I can't remember if he walks off or not, but the interview is cut short because he's so standoffish and hostile with Terry Gross. It's kind of like, you know, she'd be like, "So why are you into this?" And he'd be like, "Why are you into it?" That kind of thing.
But
look it up,
Simmons,
man.
Anyway.
It's totally worth
a
listen.
Him. That's what I
it's
think.
Not happy with
Gene Simmons.
Simmons
was trying to fuck my chick.
At the time.
When?
And he knew it was
about a year ago.
He knew it was my chick. And then he came right from there because she was
Is he married?
Channel 11. Yeah, they have that
open marriage thing. Fucking relationship.
One of those open relationships.
Him and Shannon Tweedy?
Shannon Tweedy, yeah.
Is she allowed to have sex with other people?
Apparently not. I think it's open on his side.
We kind of asked that, yeah.
Yeah.
So she can't have sex with other people, but he can?
Yeah, yeah. Gene, the way he explains it, it's totally
how do you,
fine.
How do you hook that up?
I don't know.
Kiss money.
But he's been, yeah.
Think so?
Yeah, yes. He holds up the dollars. I've trademarked wives that only can fuck you, and you can fuck everybody else.
Trademarked,
right. Him with his dollar sign. Yeah, so he was trying to, like, bang my chick at the time.
Right.
And he knew it was my girl. And then he comes over here,
to do our show.
Right.
And he like kind of, he was like, yeah, I was over there to Channel 11 over there. And I was like, oh, yeah, wow. Got a girl over there. Yeah, yeah, I know. And then he wasn't saying anything about it. And then he was like, yeah, well, maybe tonight I'll just fuck your girlfriend. I was like, oh, I'm laughing, like, oh, boy, like, he didn't know who it was or something. Like, why would he say? And coincidentally, he had just done an interview over there and everything. But he knew, and he was, like, fucking with me.
Really?
Disrespecting me right there, live, on my show. So, since then, fuck Gene Simmons. He's fucking clown shoes.
He's dead. You're dead. He's dead to
if
you.
If I may quote you.
Clown shoes.
Fucking clown shoes.
Yeah, but then you watch, like, Kiss Meets the Phantom, and you're like, all right, well, at least there was good movies.
Or you look at that comic, and you're like, I'm reading a comic that was printed with their blood.
Their blood.
Blood, yes. Man.
I saw those photos when I was a boy.
I had the 12-inch dolls.
Yeah. Those are worth a lot of money if you have
they
a
are. If you got a mint in the box.
Yeah, I don't have that. No. I got the Paul all loose. You know, I don't
do
have
you?
The, yeah.
Oh, you got one, though, Jimmy?
Like
I legs akimbo and shit.
Something tells me.
Yeah. It came that way. I had a couple of them. I had Gene and Paul. I never got Peter and Ace.
I was never a big Kiss guy.
No.
My cousin was a huge Kiss guy. My friend Walter Flanagan's a huge Kiss guy.
I think you got to be a little fucking
But, you
crazy.
Know, I did like, I loved, you know, Kiss Meets the Phantom in the Park, and I had the comic book.
Who wouldn't love that? Because we were watching clips of it the other day, and Gene with his growl and the great acting.
Easy cat, man.
Easy it's cat, funny. Man. Oh, shut up. There's a douchey movie.
There's
that
a funny
is.
Scene where Gene is breaking apart a concession stand.
Oh, yeah, that's great.
And
one take.
But he obviously walks through and kind of trip walks through
falls.
The end of it.
Yeah.
He falls. Through, the, please show Kevin that it's because they only obviously had one of these to break up, and they said break it apart. You can't. You have to watch it, but you can see that he trips over something, and it doesn't. He doesn't fall, but it doesn't look.
Yeah, it's made of styrofoam, so they couldn't put it back together or anything. They had one, so he's bashing through it, and he trips,
and then
you can tell he fell.
They just left it in the film.
It's fantastic,
it's amazing.
A man of his stature might fall and trip.
Yeah, he would have trouble walking through concession stands that weren't actually made of wood. All right, let's see.
Here it is.
This is the worst kind of radio. The kind of radio when you watch TV. Yeah.
When you're watching
on the radio.
But we do it so much now that people, you know,
we
tell
people
them.
What it is.
That's maybe the time they use to go to the bathroom or something.
Yeah, yeah.
Like
take a little breather. It's like the drum solo.
All right, we're just kind of fast forwarding through.
Trying to find it.
And now when you explain as we're trying to look, it's even worse.
But people,
it?
At least in this, oh, Gene's breaking through a wall. I forgot about that. He broke through walls.
And that's Kehoe from fucking 48 Hours. He's one of the cops.
Yeah. It's good music, at least.
Hey, quick. This is Jay. I'm at Station 48.
Can't
he gets
be stopped.
Back up here.
Yeah.
Don't
you well, he it. Might be the demon robot.
Don't you get it, pigs? Oh, he's putting
wow,
fire.
Great
oh,
wow. Great special effects.
Yeah, amazing. The fire's coming out of his mouth. It looks like really fire.
It's great CGI.
He used to do that on stage, though, didn't he?
He still does, yes.
Look at the stalking.
He's stalking the police. Why aren't they shooting him?
I don't think they have cops. Guns. Are they real cops or are they just opera? Are they just Phantom of the Park cops?
Phantom of the Park cops? They got no guns?
Yeah, probably not. They're like guards.
It's so weird. Even now, even though I know what Gene Simmons looks like, I can't see Gene Simmons under that makeup.
No.
Still to this day.
You can't picture that fucking guy talking about money and finance.
Oh, shit. He's throwing the fucking cops around. This is assaulting an officer.
Yeah.
Why won't these cops?
I don't know. They're all just staring at the demon.
The slow motion. Listen to this music. It's just.
It's Bionic Man stuff.
It's every bad episode of Chips.
How about Kiss music?
Here he goes to the stand. This is it right here. Little growl. And then watch.
Look at this thing.
Just
here he goes.
Whoops!
He toppled a bit.
Oh, and that was, and then they go to commercial.
Yeah, they had
a. So as a little kid, you were like, "Oh my God, yep. Gene destroyed a candy counter."
That's fucking great, man. Love that stupid movie.
I probably watched that 30. My goal is to get to Anthony's house and watch it on his 11-foot screen. We have
yes,
to watch
the
that.
Theater.
Yeah, so we got the Kiss interview from WGAN.
I want to hear this because it just backs up everything everybody knows already, but that I've been saying, and the reason I can't stand when especially Gene Simmons comes in. I know, Jimmy, now I know you're friends with Gene, and I wouldn't want to drag you into this, but I'm just saying me personally, I am not a fan of Gene Simmons.
I'm not a fan of Gene Simmons either, Jimmy. I'm Team Ace.
He just comes.
I do love Ace.
Ace is the shit.
Ace is the place.
Oh! Ace is coming back in. The 25th, I believe we have.
That was a little wordplay on my part.
It was very good.
Thank you. Thank you. No, even Ace doesn't like Gene. He pretty much said it during the last...
Oh, Ace was on stage in, at the Viper Room.
Yeah.
And he was talking... Because Tommy Thayer now, who's doing Ace's job...
Part.
Has fucking, like, some, like, lightning bolts on his, like, new costume.
Oh, shit.
And Ace is on stage. And he goes, yeah, I saw the new Kiss costumes. Tommy Thayer's got lightning bolts going down his leg. Where the fuck did he get that idea from?
With that New York accent.
Yeah, why don't they do something original? Ace is just the shit.
He doesn't care.
He's,
it's crazy.
He's coming back in. Yeah, he's coming back
he's
in.
He's fucking... And the way he plays... He has a weird way of playing. Like, I can't... Anthony could probably describe it. But, like, usually you think of holding the guitar, the pick between your thumb and pointer finger.
Yeah.
And playing it. But Ace has this really weird long... He's like, his whole wrist bends
oh,
into
really?
The guitar.
He's bent, so it's almost like... Yeah, I've seen that.
He's such a weird style. Because he probably has a really big fingers and a huge penis.
And he
guess.
Never looks like he's going to make it to the mic in time.
Dude, it's the, you got to watch him.
I love that
it's,
part.
It's like, we're back. He always, Ace just kind of falls into it and lucks up.
Yeah.
It's the fucking,
hey,
the most.
There's a mic there in front of me again.
I want to just run up and go, Ace, where are you going? You have a lyric coming up in 3 seconds.
How about when he's walking away from the mic when the lyric is coming
that,
up?
That,
like,
that, that,
he's
that.
Walking away and then kind of comes back. Oh,
here it
we're
is.
Back. It's like, whoa, shit. What's he doing?
why are we getting emails from HR?
What? Puffin stuff. What I hate that guy. He's your friend when things get rough. No?
Yes.
Yes.
I'm really going back on
all
that
right.
one.
So Kiss was on WGN. And we noticed this a while ago. That, like, something happened with Gene where Gene would be a cool interview. When we interviewed him at WNEW, it was a cool interview. But then he would kind of promote all the Kiss stuff.
Constantly.
Now it's an all out. But now it's a lot worse. It's all out. It's just about promoting. And you know, the interviewer is sitting there like, well, you're not giving us anything. That's what these people are supposed to do. They come in here, you interview them. They give you something that's worth it for the radio show.
Give us a laugh, a fun story.
Right. And then we go, all right, what are you working on? And then you get the word out that way.
Something from the past.
Right.
But anything.
But not with Gene Simmons. No, no, no. This is how it went down on WGN.
Joining us now from Los Angeles, Gene Simmons, Paul Stanley, Tommy Thayer, and Eric Singer. Guys, good morning.
Good morning.
It's good to see you.
Morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hey, guys, am I wrong? Are there a couple of names that are different from the Kiss I remember?
Well, you know, it depends on how far back you go, but Eric's been playing with us off and on for 14 years, and Tommy's been with us about 7 years, so it's about as classic as I want to get, and we just we finished the international part of the Kiss Alive 35 World Tour, and we played to the biggest crowds, most successful tour we've ever done of stadiums, and now we're back on home turf. So here we are doing Kiss Alive 35, and we'll be hitting United Center on November 6th, and the tickets go on sale September 26th.
All
so
right.
We wouldn't miss it for the world, and you shouldn't either.
That's the warm-up club.
There's the plug.
But you notice that there was a legitimate question that turned into a plug.
Did Paul say we're doing this September 6th, and the tickets go on sale September 26th? Did Paul give the worst plug in history?
Did he say that?
Yeah. Can you? Is there a possible rewind?
September
6th? I could be wrong.
Joining us now.
A little forward through
there. Oh, that's good.
Come on.
I hope so.
I don't know.
Kiss has become a rock and roll infomercial. Very good.
Here we are doing Kiss Alive 35, and we'll be hitting United Center on November 6th, and the tickets go on sale September 26th.
November,
we wouldn't miss it for the world, and you shouldn't
said
either. Yeah,
okay.
My fault. Yeah, I just was hoping he fucked
right. So
Paul organically brings up some of the band's new projects.
Gene and Paul, you guys take time out for Rosh Hashanah and the holidays?
You know, every day to us is a day to be thankful for what you have. And, you know, Sonic Boom is coming out on October 6th. It is the first album we've done in 11 years, and it's a classic Kiss album with all the elements that people love. Plus, it's packaged with 15 re-records of Kiss classics and a DVD from Buenos Aires, the stadium show we did there.
Oh, my God.
It's a Walmart exclusive, and they made it possible for us to give this to our fans at a price which is less than you would pay for a single CD. And they're also giving us these amazing Kiss Corners where you can get incredible exclusive Kiss merchandise in each city. It's a pretty special time for us.
This is like...
That was a Rosh Hashanah question. First of all, they hit him with the Jew question, which is kind of funny. It's like, you know, I don't think they like reminding people that they are of Hebrew descent. It doesn't fit their rock and roll image, tell you the truth.
This is an infomercial.
Yeah. So this they're sitting
like
there.
This is late night TV.
Ugh.
You want more? Or
please.
Yeah, okay. Sorry.
We're yelling.
Gene Simmons finally pipes in.
Gene, we met Paul the other day when he came into our studios, and we asked him, did you think for all these years later you'd still be wearing the makeup? I mean, what do you think is the secret to the longevity of this band?
The secret is, if you're going to dream, dream big. It's as simple as that. Reach for the sky. Go for it. And that's what Kiss is about. A long time ago, we dreamt about putting together the band we never saw on stage. Guess what? We are going to be on stage. Chicago, November 6th. You want to see the best, the greatest? You're looking at them.
Wow.
You know something?
It all leads to a plug.
It's fucking disgraceful.
It's brilliant on his part. He knows what
it's
he's doing.
It's disgraceful. Have a little bit of fucking restraint. Answer one question without tagging it with a fucking plug.
Oh. Tommy ends the interview with a quick and natural mention of their show in Chicago,
which
Paul helps with.
Is there ever a point, though, where you go, I'm tired of putting this damn makeup on? I look like a buffoon.
It's 8 o'clock in the morning, for crying out loud.
That ever come?
Oh, we always wear makeup. It's
so it's a regular thing. All right, never mind then. I solved that one.
Guys.
But I wanted to add that at United Center on November 6th, we're bringing in the biggest and the baddest Kiss show there's ever been. It's the biggest stage we've ever taken out. We have a video screen and pyro and everything that's way beyond anything we've done before. So,
you know, in a time where money is hard to come by, you know, you can buy a high-priced ticket and see some guy sitting on a stool on a rug, you know, and they call it an intimate show. Well, when you come see us, you know where your money is because it's blinding you and deafening you.
Right. No stools and no rugs, Larry. Right. You heard it here first. Thanks, guys.
Thanks. What was the date of that again? November 6th?
November 6th. Oh,
see, they're even fuck. Like, enough about November 6th.
God.
Enough about November 6th.
Shut the fuck up. That's what I have to say to Kiss. Shut the fuck up.
I do not echo those sentiments at all.
Well, I know. Jimmy Norton.
My favorite Gene Simmons moment ever.
My Matt.
The banana moment was way up there.
Yeah.
But I have to go to Danny. When Danny was pretty much.
Oh! Yeah.
Pretty much stopped in his tracks. Didn't he touch your arm to make you stop typing? Oh,
yeah. Didn't even look at him. Didn't stop talking. See, Gene is talking about something very important.
Absolutely.
I don't know what it was. Kiss fucking
coffee
dildos,
or something. Yeah.
Kiss coffee. Yeah. Kiss fucking false eyelashes. Kiss shampoo.
I'd love those things.
And he's going and he's going off. And now Danny, of course, the entire time is Danny does research and pulls shit up during the entire show. So you'll hear, like, on the keyboard, slightly.
Slightly, and, like, especially at the old studio, the mics picked up a lot, and he was sitting, like, right next to me. So I was even, I'm conscious to that, so I was kind of trying to type, you know, lightly, because I knew it was going to bleed over a little bit. And I guess that was even too much for Gene as he reached his hand kind of under my computer monitor, like a flat monitor on a stand, and just kind of touched my hand just as if to say just for a few minutes.
And
just
picture the way he did it also was he was looking at me and Opie like back and forth as he's talking about his products and all of his Kiss products. And he did not stop doing that. He didn't stop talking. He didn't stop looking directly at us. Didn't acknowledge Danny. Just moved his hand over and put his hand down on Danny's hand like, I'm talking, don't type.
Very softly.
Very softly.
Yeah.
Yes. His hands are soft from counting money all his life.
He has a problem with
tie me a sheep shank.
Yeah. You like to spit fire, don't you, Mr. Hooper?
Can we play the banana incident?
The banana incident?
Yeah.
I don't know about that one.
You do, Jimmy.
I don't.
That's a good one.
I'm just a generous guy.
That is a good one.
This is Jimmy, J-I-M-I, Gene Simmons, and a banana.
How was it? I got to because, you know, roasting Gene was you know, you think.
Can I take a bite?
Sure, you can have the whole thing. I'll actually share it with you if you want.
you just wanted to have a moment
for the rest share of your it with life. You, if you want. You stick it up your ass. I'll eat it afterwards.
It reminds me of when I was in, I think, fourth or fifth grade. Or no, seventh grade. Billy, this kid, Billy Archer, was, he was like,
hello, Bill.
He was one of the tough guys around the neighborhood.
Yeah.
He never bothered me, but we were all kind of scared of him. You know, he's like a burnout and I remember one time, I might have even been sixth grade, where he asked for a, like, he's like, you got a nickel? And I gave him a dime. And I'm like, I waited a few seconds. I'm like, you don't have to pay me back.
Oh.
So I was hoping we'd bond over that.
Yeah, yeah. But you didn't.
I have to say not.
You don't bond with somebody who's shaking you down. It's pretty
well. Well, no, he actually was just asking me, like, you got a nickel?
Oh, he was?
Yeah. And I was like, but then I told him you didn't have to pay me back. Yeah,
you don't have to pay me back. Easy come, easy go.
Yeah.
I had it and I went with it.
I had a dime. Billy had a dime.
If I had it and you needed it,
I gave it to you.
Gene Simmons is on TV. He blew off our show.
I don't know if he's doing. He's not even on the facility, though. He's not here.
Don't defend him.
I'm being honest.
You can still like the guy, but don't defend him. Fuck Gene Simmons.
I would.
What's he? He's hawking a big book, I guess.
A big coffee table kiss book, and he's signing. I'll even at Borders. I don't know when, though, in the Time Warner building. His I might go.
His hair looks ridiculous.
What's going on there?
It looks ridiculous.
I want that fucking book badly.
All right, go buy it. No, you want me to buy it for
you? I'll buy it, yes.
All right.
Kiss Canendium or whatever?
Merry Christmas.
All right, I'll buy it for Jimmy. Someone get Jimmy the Kiss book.
I want Gene
Jimmy
to sign it.
Jimmy needs to be happy.
I want Gene to sign it.
I'll sign it as Gene. No
I'm
problem.
I'm trying to figure out what he's done with his hair.
It's a wig.
Yeah.
So he's got a lot of money. Get a good wig. That's horrendous.
Awful wig.
And it looks like it's spray painted on the that left side.
It's not a natural flowing looking wig.
The best line,
it looks like cotton candy.
The best line was in
For
the
real.
Roast when Lisa Lampanelli said, "I've seen better rugs in the back of a rape van." That to me was the right. best line of the roast.
That's
was fucking
funny.
Lisa slamming his wig.
When is she gonna come on our show? I ran into her on the street. She wants to do our show, but she's scared how the other people are gonna take it. Just come on our show.
What, Jimmy?
Wow.
I still get excited when I see Kiss.
Why?
I don't know.
You are really a weirdo.
I know. I'm sorry. I don't know why I do.
I love when it says weirdo.
It's just a strange fixation to have.
I don't know why.
You're a little baby.
So you're mad that they're not in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame again?
Oh, yeah.
Disgusted. Not that, you know what, dude?
They just should be. It's ridiculous. Stop with this cool fucking attitude.
They put ABBA in. ABBA. To say ABBA doesn't deserve it, though... You know what? It's like, that's my reaction as a Kiss fan, but ABBA's record sales worldwide were fucking...
So it's based on record
massive.
Sales?
No, I'm only saying they're very big, but ABBA was more disco than rock and roll, aren't they?
Not disco, like...
They were poppy, pop.
Yeah, they're poppy, pop.
The fact,
pop.
So ABBA was put in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame over Kiss.
Well, how many... units did ABBA sell?
A lot, I'm sure. I mean, more than Kiss.
And then
I'm
they
guessing.
Had a fucking... Supposedly, they hate each other, and there's deals on the table where I forgot what the number was. We talked about it on the show where they want to pay ABBA a ridiculous amount of money to get back
man,
together.
Yeah,
but they hate each other so much that they can't even do it just for the money.
No, huh?
But
give me the story of ABBA because it's pretty amazing what happened to these guys. They hate each other and they refuse to get back together for just a boatload of cash.
The fact that Kiss is not in the hall. Is fucking disgusting.
It's ridiculous.
It is what the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame is, and I'm glad I attacked them in my book because they're fucking shit. They really are shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
To not put Kiss in is fucking despicable.
Kiss had a really good run. Continues to have a good run.
Continued success.
You know what?
Continued success.
They really did fucking. I mean, they were the biggest rock band in the world. They were like larger than life.
And you know. Steve from Bayshore says, Kiss shouldn't even be allowed to visit the Hall of Fame.
That's not true.
He's not a big fan, I guess.
I understand that. He likes Elvis, and, you know, that's fair enough.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, exactly. Shooby-dooby.
Christmas.
Shooby-dooby douche, Steve. But, you know, look.
Elvis was a one-hit wonder. Let's be honest with you.
I don't like a Jew.
People are asking us to ask you about Gene Simmons, and I did not see that episode, and I'm sorry
Gene
that I did
Simmons.
Not.
Gene Simmons, with this makeup and this tongue and the singing, and the, casts a shadow. I mean, you think, oh, my God, he's a weird guy.
Yeah.
Turns out that Gene... is a Holocaust, his mother is a Holocaust survivor.
Mm-hmm.
They went to live in dirt on the floor poor circumstances in Israel till he was about 10 or 12. Came here, wasn't quite dirt poor, but was poor. Mother survived by working. He lived in such dire circumstances that this child began to look for ways to survive and miraculously picks up a guitar and thinks about what will make a character. The story of Gene Simmons is so touching about somebody who is in survival mode the whole time, and even now, not even now, all his life, he's in survival mode.
Mm. We've had Gene on many times. We didn't get that out of him. He was too busy plugging everything.
Too busy trying to pick up my girlfriend at the time, too.
Yeah, he was trying to pick up Ann's girlfriend. Bastard. He was plugging the Did he? Kiss thing.
Did he?
I don't know. I'll tell you the truth.
That's what, is she still your girlfriend?
No.
Now there's another problem.
Traffic girl over Channel 11.
Is your girlfriend now?
Well, she was.
Well, you want to tell Bill the story?
No, tell me the story.
It's a good
story. This is a good story.
What's your girlfriend doing on the show right now?
What's Gene doing? What is your girlfriend doing on the show while Gene's on?
Well, she was doing the interview.
You might have.
Because she's the traffic girl and sometimes the interview girl. This is going back like, you know, year and a half.
She's on TV right now, Bill. We might see her.
Oh, yeah.
I'd love to take a look. And have you got a telephone number?
And then she... I don't think I'll be sending any texts after what happened.
It was a terrific ending to this relationship. Well, you might want to ask him about it.
It was a whirlwind romance that lasted an entire summer a couple of years ago. And we had a very good time and everything.
Really? It was like Greece.
Yes, it was like Greece. It was wonderful for a summer. And then I kind of... hooked up with somebody at a party at my house, which is a bad thing to do. You can't really get away. And
you played her false, Anthony.
She walked into the bedroom and found the girl in the walk-in closet.
Hiding there,
yes.
And you were under the covers.
And
hiding there behind all the guns.
And you're blaming Gene?
No, well, that was before when everything was okay. Gene kind of got her in the newsroom and was, making all kinds of remarks, and then came on our show right afterwards and said, if you don't watch out, I'll screw your girlfriend. And I kind of laughed because I didn't know what had transpired before until she called me up and told me, hey, Gene Simmons was pulling some, stuff.
Some moves.
Trying to, he was being very inappropriate. I'm like, that son of a bitch came on here knowing that was my girlfriend and gave me some crap without me knowing, so I just laughed it off.
I wonder what goes through one's mind doing that on the air.
It's
risky.
That's the kind of guy that I see Gene Simmons as being. He's a little vindictive.
Well, I don't know, but I don't know that.
Maybe
guy.
It's from the pain of growing up.
Right.
I don't know.
The guy I know touched my heart.
Yeah,
and
he got a different Gene.
I got Gene Simmons.
What, Gene, I might have gotten? The one that beamed up in the broken transporter and divided into good and evil, Gene.
See, but that's
evil,
a very
Gene.
Painful process.
That I understand.
It feels like your insides are being ripped
apart. Being ripped apart, and then putting back together is a very difficult procedure. And thank God, Captain Kirk.
Man, it's not real. It's not real.
It together.
It was a TV show.
Because they couldn't survive without each other.
But the strong the Gene and the weak Simmons part. Interview on Ron Irv.
Bio channel.
On the bio channel.
Tuesdays, 10 o'clock.
Yeah. Oh, thanks. I didn't know that. And is one of many touching interviews where you find the guy.
Mm-hmm.
And suddenly Gene Simmons is a real guy to me.
What does he mean by that? Pulled the trigger of my love gun.
I think he actually, in 1977 when I got this record, you'd get like a little paper gun with it.
Oh, you would?
With like a love gun. I would point it at people. And get molested.
I guess we're playing this because Gene Simmons is 61 years old today.
Wow.
61 for Gene, yeah.
Oh, happy birthday there, you fucking prick.
Still holding a grudge, huh? I don't blame you, though.
As a fucking backstabbing asshole.
See, I hold a grudge because he had to, hold Danny's hand. So yeah, Danny wouldn't type anymore.
I
hold a grudge.
Against Danny?
I do like
too. Gene's talking.
Should be typing. The way he did it, too. He leaned over a little, didn't even acknowledge or look at Danny. He just put his hand on Danny's hand to make Danny stop typing.
Because he was making too much noise.
It was like, it was one of these moves. And just as he's talking... He just
reached for Danny's hand. He didn't even want to look Danny in the eye.
Like, stop it, jerk.
Gene Simmons is an asshole.
What an ass wipe.
Can we play some Gene Simmons clips today in honor of his birthday?
Why?
My favorite is where when Jimmy tried to share the banana with him.
Gene was hungry and I had a banana. What am I, selfish?
That is great.
That was a good one.
Can you find it real fast before we get into it with Pete Dominic?
With Jimmy sharing the banana.
Does anybody want a brownie, though?
It's actually, I had a little teeny bite of one.
Very good.
Yeah, well, here it is. In honor of Gene Simmons' birthday, check this out.
How was it? I gotta, because you know, roasting Gene was you know, he's like.
Can I take a bite?
Sure, you can have the whole thing. I'll actually share it with you if you want.
Oh God!
Why would you share a banana with someone?
The question is, why wouldn't you?
Come on, Jimmy.
Do you hear the desperation yes. in your voice?
Come if on. He would have put half in his mouth, I would have eaten the other half till our lips met.
Did you want the story that you once shared a banana with Gene?
Never occurred to me.
I got to hear it again because there's the as a matter of fact, like no, you could have it, could have it, and then he thought like. Wait a minute. This is my opportunity to share a banana with Gene Simmons. I don't want to sound too excited, but I'm going to present it. I'm going to put it out.
All right, let's listen again.
You have to throw it out.
How was it? I got to because you know roasting Gene was you know he's like.
Can I take a bite?
Sure, you can have the whole thing. I'll actually share it with you if you want.
correction. You cannot have the whole thing. Two men can enjoy a banana together.
I'll actually share it with you. You wanted to share your banana.
I meant my girlfriend's pussy. Take whatever you want, Gene. Hop in there. Do what you got to do, pal.
Oh, that is fantastic.
Wonderful.
Yeah, Terry Gross, she's been a pro for forever, man. Like, whoever she interviews, I mean, she usually pulls something good out of them. Did you ever hear that fucking Gene Simmons interview she did?
No.
Because she hosts Fresh Air on NPR, if I'm remembering correctly. She did an interview with Gene Simmons. It's available somewhere online. Can you look up Gene Simmons, NPR, Fresh Air, or something like that? Where he is so over the top hostile to her, almost like the comedy writer.
Oh man, really?
Like, and he keeps, there's a chip on his shoulder about NPR. Like he keeps saying, like you and your NPR people, like you know, as if.
Well, he's much more conservative probably than they are. He probably has a political thing with them because he's Gene's conservative.
Pretty, is he really?
Much more conservative, I think, than they are. Yeah.
I mean, can you play this sort of thing, or is it?
Yeah, it's a little long.
It is long. He kind of goes
like
at her the first.
Up on stage yeah, let's go. And make you feel any less vulnerable or any less like Gene Simmons or your other names, Gene Klein or Chaim Weitz, which was your birth name.
Close but no guitars. It's Chaim Witz.
Oh, thanks. Okay.
You said it. Well, the name came out through Gentile mouth, so it didn't quite have the flavor. Oh. It came out bland.
All right, now stop it real quick.
Yeah.
I don't know anything about him. Is that a sense of humor?
He might have been being slightly sarcastic, but Gene is a weird guy.
You know what that was? She pulled out like that, all right, look what I know about you kind of thing. And he didn't like the fact that... Oh, you're just saying this because you think you know more than everybody else.
It gets worse.
And he gets, There's and he is that. Like that. He's a nasty man.
We've had him on the show.
That's my opinion. Not Jimmy's.
I like him.
I find him to be a nasty man.
I'm with Anthony. I still like Kiss, but he's just a dick.
And what he did to Danny.
Explain
that
the
day
Danny thing. Kevin will love this story.
Danny is constantly trolling for stuff on the internet. That's part of his job here on the show. So he's next to Gene Simmons.
Studio is smaller. It's the old XM place.
Yeah.
Well, the board is.
And Danny's doing this. Now, that's what you'd hear. It's just fucking. And Gene's talking. Without looking over at Danny or missing a beat with him talking, he continues talking. He puts his hand over on top of Danny's hands to make him stop typing while he's talking. And we were just like...
That's like an elder statesman move.
Yeah.
And condescending at the same time.
So condescending.
Extremely. Extremely.
Completely unnecessary.
Very.
And so just...
It wasn't like it was type. It was...
He wasn't banging away on the fucking keyboard. Right.
I met him in a comic book store out in Los Angeles at Golden Apple many, many years ago, back when it was on its other location, its original location. And Bill Leibowitz, guy who owned the store, who's passed now, he was just like, have you ever met Gene Simmons? And I was like, no. I was not a big Kiss guy, but my friend Walter was a huge Kiss guy. So just in honor of that, I was just like, I got to meet him so I could tell Walter I met Gene Simmons. So I went over and he introduced us. I was like, hey, man, how are you? And within, no lie, 2 minutes, he had whipped out a notebook and was showing me all these projects that he was involved in.
Yes.
He was showing me off his resume. And then he flipped the page and he showed me a bag with money on it. So Gene flips the page and he shows me a bag. Like a drawing of a bag with a dollar sign.
Oh, right. Yeah.
And I was just like, right on. What is that? He goes, see this? This is going to make me, this is my future. This is going to make me a billionaire. And I said, what is it? And he goes, nobody ever thought to copyright the dollar sign on a money bag, so I did it. So I was like, "You're really? Can you just do
can
that?
Can you do that?
And I guess you could,
isn't it
but
in
it's kind
every
of a dick
cartoon
move.
Where there's a crook?
But he said at a certain point, like, it was a couple of years it would kick in that if Monopoly wanted to show, you know, money bags running around holding the money bags, whatever that character's name on the Monopoly game, yeah. they were going to have to cut him a check or something.
Holy shit.
It's kind of weird. It's like squatting, like cyber squatting. Like,
yeah,
hey, man,
really
you know what? You know what, Earl? I bought SexInTheCityTheMovie.com. You know, it's like, why would you do that, dude? Like, well, rainy day.
Never know.
Yeah. All right, so let's see.
Oh, let's hear Nasty Gene.
Not a Gentile mouth.
Ooh, maybe it's a discussion we can have.
Yeah, okay.
But let's not start something we're not going to finish.
Right.
But in terms of the... what was the question about makeup?
Oh, did you like being covered up by makeup, and did it make you feel less vulnerable or... You know, less like Gene Simmons, Gene Klein, or your birth name.
I don't feel covered up any more or less than any girl feels covered up when she wears makeup. The makeup is simply an extension of a personality, and colors, clothing, makeup all express something. And getting up on stage was a chance to sort of live out the, sort of a scream therapy meets a rock and roll band version. I wanted to put together the band I never saw on stage. I wanted to be in a band that gave bang for the buck. I wanted to be in a band that didn't look like a bunch of guys who, you know, should be in a library studying for their finals. You know, I wanted stars up on stage. And regular people just didn't look big enough. So we wore 8-inch platform heels, put on more makeup and higher heels than your mother, and made more money than your banker. It all kind of works out.
How can you make rock and roll sound
did
that
you
boring?
Him?
I know.
And paint by numbers.
Yeah. He's just like, so we decided.
Yeah, it was a logical progression.
Yes. Well, it really sounds natural and organic.
We could cut to the chase. E-Rock just sent in all the highlights where...
Do it, yeah. Can we jump, please?
Yeah, where they go at it. We'll start with this track, talking about money. Or was that it, maybe? I don't know. Let's start here.
Are you trying to say that all that matters to you is money?
I will... contend, and you try to disprove it, that the most important thing as we know it on this planet and this plane is in fact money. You want me to prove it?
Go ahead.
The first thing you need besides air, which so far is free, and by the way, if you went scuba diving, you're paying for air. The other thing besides that is food. It's what we need to survive. I don't know what other tool I would use besides money to buy it. Although, as a woman, of course, you have the ability to sell your body, then get the money, and then with that, get food. But ultimately, money is part of it.
You are weird.
Really? How do you get food?
Oh, well, not by selling my body, but...
But that's a choice you have that I don't.
See, that's what started, right?
Yeah, right there.
And then it...
That is the most inane logic I've ever heard. It's ridiculous, retarded, obnoxious. He can't be real.
It sounds
like
the kind of conversation you would have when you were like 15, 16.
Yeah, yeah.
Kind of thing.
You want me to prove it? You want me to prove it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Prove. First of all, he's not proving anything. You're giving your take on something.
Yeah, it's more like, I think you've given an example.
Yeah, an example. How about people that just live in the mountains and hunt?
They trade sex for food, apparently.
Sex for food, yeah, or fuck their food.
Yes.
You could fuck a moose and then eat it.
Is there more? Is there
oh,
more?
Yeah, it gets way better.
There's a bunch, right?
That's just the beginning.
How much money do you have?
Gee, a lot more than NPR.
I know. You're very defensive on money, aren't you?
Mm. No, I'm not. I'm actually just trying to show you that there's a big world out there, and reading books is wonderful. I've certainly read... Well, perhaps as many as you have, but there's a delusional kind of notion that runs rampant in...
Wait, can we just get something straight?
Of course.
I'm not here to prove that I'm smart, and
not
I'm not
you.
Here to prove that you're not smart or that you don't read books
not,
or can't make a lot of money.
This is not about you. You're being very defensive. Why are you doing
that? Oh, God. He's a passive-aggressive cunt. Fuck Gene Simmons and his fucking asshole.
Isn't that weird?
I hate him.
Kiss Alive 2 is fucking great.
What an album.
What an album. Destroyer.
That's all that should matter.
God of Thunder.
All you have to do is separate the work from the man.
Exactly. That's all that matters.
Still dig the work. I mean, because it wasn't just him. It's three other guys.
Yeah.
And it continues here.
Now, let's get to the studded cod piece. Do you have a sense of humor about that? I mean, does that seem funny to you? Or you?
No, it holds in. it holds in my manhood. Otherwise,
that's right.
It would be too much for you to take. You'd have to put the book down and confront life.
Not
the
everyone wants to fuck you, Gene.
Ever talking about the book, too. He's like a real anti-intellectual or something, because he keeps, like, ribbing her for reading.
Yeah, yeah. Wow.
He's like, if you put down a book and suck a cock, you'd know what I'm talking about. He's like, what are you talking about?
He's such an asshole.
The question is that if you want to welcome me with open arms, I'm afraid you're also going to have to welcome me with open legs.
That's a really obnoxious thing to say.
No, it's not. It's why should I say something behind your back that I can't tell you to your face?
Wait, has it come to this? Is this the only way that you can talk to a woman to do that shtick?
Let me ask you something. Why is it shtick when all women have ever wanted, ever since we've crawled out of caves, is why can't a man just tell me the truth and just speak to me plainly? So if I do that, you can't have it both ways.
So you really have no sense of humor about this, do you?
Oh, I'm laughing all the way, you know.
Oh, to the bank, right?
Well, of course. Don't I sound like a happy guy?
Not really, to be honest with you.
I was going to suggest you get outside of the musty place where you can count the dust particles falling around you and get out in the world and see what everybody else is doing.
Having sex with you?
Well, if you chose, but you'd have to stand in line.
Oh, stop it.
Who wouldn't fuck the God of Thunder? I submit a lot of women would love to have their pussy eaten by
God
that tongue.
The God of Thunder.
Who wouldn't? Saying he's fucking phenomenal.
You think he's getting a lot of pussy, or is that a shtick?
Of course he is. It's
no, I think he got lots and lots and lots.
But he's been with that one broad forever.
He said that they've had an open relationship, I thought, no?
I think half of what he says is complete bullshit,
right,
and the other half is exaggeration. Him and, what's his name, Sharon Tweed?
Shannon Tweed.
They've been together forever. They have this open relationship. But I think that was just shtick and a fucking, you know, a publicity stunt thing.
Can I ask this?
I think during the heyday of Kiss, yeah, the guy probably got a fuckload of pussy.
Yeah, but fuck that. Like, the Family Jewels is the name of the show.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
The fake scripted.
Well, that's what I'm asking. Like,
show.
That show's been on enough. Do they show Gene, like, chasing other women, having sex with other women?
It's so fake. No.
Seems like a normal, regular household, but they're not officially married to me.
Right.
The little I've seen of the show.
Great reality show, second only to the Osbournes.
Oh, it's terrible.
Shows you the inner workings of a rock star's life.
I watched one episode the other day because I criticize it all the time, and it's so fake. Like, you know this didn't happen. And I like the fake people that come over the house to do work or something, and they're actually really angry, yet they signed the fucking release, and they're not so angry with her leaving.
That's the thing. Every time you see somebody blow up on a reality show, it's like, just tell yourself, they signed a release.
They signed a release.
No matter how mad they may seem in this moment,
they
were okay with it getting there.
Yeah.
Or maybe they signed it beforehand. Gene would do that because he's smart. I'm not defending Family Jewels just because there was a roast and I happen to be a part of it. Who cares? You got nothing to do with it.
Is there more?
Gene.
Oh, there's more.
Stinks.
One of them leaves. If I remember correctly, I think one of them leaves.
Yeah, I think we're getting to that point. Let's see.
Are you interested in music?
Don't you love this interview? Tell me the truth.
Well, I think it's kind of a drag because you're making speeches and you're being intentionally obnoxious.
No, I'm not. I'm being a man.
That's what I mean. You're being intentionally obnoxious by defining everything that you're saying as being a man.
Well, I can't.
I know better. I know all men.
No, I always define it the way that you're
speaking.
You're wrong. I always defined it as for me. I kept doing that over and over again. What bothers you is you're finally hearing a man tell the truth. Instead of, you're the only one I'll ever live with and you're the... He's lying. He's lied ever since he was 12. I promise I'll pull out. He's lying. And I refuse to play that game. I refuse to stand up in front of a rabbi and my friends and the woman I love, who I will tell you I can love with all my heart, and promise that she's going to be the only one I will ever have until the day I die. That's a lie.
I'm watching The Luckiest Girl in the World right now.
This is the girl that's... Is that really him?
That's Gene, yeah.
Yeah,
for sure?
And that was after the interview. That's Terry Gross. So.
Wow.
Oh, no, it's not.
I like the fact Gene's pants are still on, and he's kneeling on the bed, and he still has his pants.
She won't kiss, though. Look, she won't kiss.
No, she don't want
to
kiss.
He keeps trying to kiss, and she won't kiss.
Pushing his face away.
And he's got his T-shirt on still, and his wig.
Oh, is she trying to kiss him?
His wig? That's a wig?
I don't know. I mean, you got to think something's going on.
I'm delighted to see someone else fuck with a shirt on, though. You never see that. I feel like I'm not alone. Maybe I do have something in common with Gene Simmons.
Well, you don't think she wanted the kiss? Wow.
No, she doesn't. It says up there. It says, before entering, in one alleged, Gene Simmons puts on a condom before entering his lady friend, who then refuses to kiss him. The reader may draw his or her own conclusion.
My conclusion would be, if
she's
I
a
had
hooker.
To, is a, she's a hooker.
Yeah, that's my conclusion.
Usually the non-kissers are
that's
hookers,
my conclusion.
Is what I've heard.
That's okay. Where they draw the line.
Yeah, kissing for them is very personal.
But oddly enough, we just saw her shuffle to the edge of the bed and take his dick in her mouth.
Yeah, right.
So didn't she have a condom on at first, though? That, to me, is what gives away that I think she's a hooker. Is it looks like there's a condom on his dick.
Yeah,
like
well, he did. It says he puts it on. He
before the blowjob, though.
Yeah, that's true.
Regular girls don't put a rubber on before she fucking blows you.
So then who's, do you think this is her place?
Yeah, yeah, he wouldn't have the camera hooked up. It's probably her hotel.
So
her
she
place.
Didn't, she, he probably didn't know what was going on.
Oh, no. No.
Hence Gene's secret.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's keep going with this interview here. Terry Gross from NPR. And
I
Gene
like
Simmons.
What she said. It's a drag.
Yeah,
it's kind of a drag.
Do you like the movie Spinal Tap? And do you think that?
Oh,
that's a tough question. I mean, at this point,
right,
if you're Terry Gross, though,
yeah,
you're grasping at straws because this dude is kind of like just been the uninterview.
That's what.
So maybe she's trying to take it to the insult level.
That's
like,
a lazy.
You remind me of those.
That's a lazy question, like you were saying earlier. Though I'm
true.
Thinking.
True.
Do you like the movie Spinal Tap? And do you think that Spinal Tap has any comment on
rock and roll?
Like
sure.
Uh-huh.
Oh yeah. Sure. I think it's all funny. I mean, when you really think about it, I'm not delusional enough to think that what I do is important to life as we know it on this planet. No, but neither is what you do. You know, the world can get along very well without us. Farmers are more important. Teachers and firemen and so on, because if they're not around, it really affects us. Your job and my job, whether you wear less makeup and I wear more makeup, is to entertain people. And I'm here to tell you, I'm very entertaining. I don't know about you, but this is NPR.
He's got a real, like, bug up his ass. Like NPR killed his parents or something.
He always has a bug up his ass. It doesn't matter
what show he does.
He thinks people look at that like, wow, look at Gene. He's really getting the most of everybody. He just comes across like a dick.
Tell Kevin the Jill story, too. That was very telling.
Oh, when he did that, yeah. No, when I was going out with Jill Nicolini, the traffic girl, Gene was doing an interview over there, and she was doing, like, the entertainment segment that day. And then Gene was coming over here. So he gets done over there, comes over here, and he starts saying shit like, you know, how about I just, fuck your girlfriend or something.
I think you told me.
Yeah.
He was like right in your face.
Yeah, he was right in my face. And I didn't know that he knew anything about us having a relationship or something like that.
Right.
So I didn't know he was being that personal. And then I find out later on that he was like pinning her in the corner of the studio, saying, yeah, why don't you come to my hotel tonight? And like, she was getting pissed about the whole thing. And then him coming here knowing, because he said, you know, she said, oh, you're going over to Open Anthony. Anthony's, you know, me and him are going out. And so he knew. And even knowing, sat in front of me, looked me right in the eyes, and completely just fucking disrespected me.
Yeah,
like
no
that.
Doubt on your show.
Like, I'll fuck your girlfriend.
Maybe I'll just do that.
Like, and if he was just like, like the generic, like if it was just a goof, like he didn't know my girlfriend, right. He didn't know, whatever. But the fact that he knew, he was just trying to like pull one over on me or something.
Well, it sounds like he likes to
disrespect.
Go into every interview scenario, kind of the way he did with you.
Yeah, yeah.
With Terry Gross as well. That?
All right, let's continue with this Terry Gross thing. Almost over.
What exactly is NPR in your mind?
I never knew. It always sounds like a sixth grade school teacher. See, if I was in charge, give me the reins, I would get National Public Radio. And people start.
Yeah, that's fair.
I actually agree with him.
That's fair. Then why is he on there doing an interview?
Because he's going to change the world. Dude, you can't just rebel from the outside. You got to change it from within.
Get in there. Yeah, you got to get in there. Yeah, that's right.
He's showing us the way.
He certainly
and
is.
People start snoring. I'm not questioning the content. You should have bright people on. Maybe you should never have me on again if you don't think I'm bright. Clearly, it should be a wonderful place for people who read and are bright to have a conversation, a discourse perhaps without hearing whatever it is you hate about the outside world. Fine. How about some style? Give me a little spice instead of this bland. You ever see the Saturday Night Live version? It's pretty spot on.
Have you listened to it enough to know if it's spot on?
Sure. I was in Los Angeles and did a quick one. P.J. O'Rourke, who's great, who wrote for Rolling Stone,
was on with myself and one other gentleman, I don't remember, and the instructor, you know, the teacher, sorry, the DJ guy gets on, good afternoon, Gene. Going, what's the matter? Why are you talking like that? What do you mean? Going, you know what? Let PJ talk. PJ the DJ. You need, as a listener, well, I would beg you guys to get...
Because he doesn't have an affected voice
I was
going
to say, with his monotone fucking...
that's a character he's playing.
Crap. Yeah, he's just, well, here we go. Blah, 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 blah. It's the same fucking thing he's doing. He's such an ass.
I would beg you guys to get something else on the air. Something with style. I changed the call letters, NPR. I change it. Give it some oomph. Lexus, Locus, something. See?
Not a fan of NPR, see? But and then I think they do pretty well, right?
Yeah, they do very well.
I think
well.
They're fine.
They're very profitable.
They have a gazillion listeners. They have more listeners than anybody, if I remember correctly.
So they're doing something right.
Every fucking cab driver in New York listens
has
to them.
It on.
Every cab driver.
And that's nationwide NPR as well.
And I think it's boring, too. I hate listening to it. I think it's terribly dull. But, you know,
it's great
it is
when
successful.
Gene's on. I'll tell you that
then
much.
Why is it so successful? If
very
it's
successful.
So dull. I don't get it.
I don't know either.
Some people like
it's I think it's talk that's kind of, it's not,
it's like
nobody's screaming at them.
Right.
It's more conversational.
Screaming at them, yeah.
You know, it's not offensive in that way.
Type of thing you can listen to when you've just come from a fucking clitoral circumcision in the sedan. Now you're driving
the
fucking...
The calm voice, the soothing voice. Yeah.
Now you're driving me to the airport at 5 in the morning.
All right, let's get through this. Gene is too into himself.
You said you don't have sympathy for that guy on the roof who keeps saying I'm going to jump. My impression is you don't have much sympathy for anyone. You're so into yourself.
Well, that's not
you're
true.
So deep
into
yourself.
I think everybody should be. If it sounds like admiration coming out of you, I accept it. I think life is too short to have anything but delusional notions about yourself, which is you should really like yourself more than you deserve to, because the alternative isn't very good. You should really think you are better looking than you are, because the alternative is sort of, you know, some bad notions. And so I'm aware, as a sane person, that I'm not the best looking guy in the world. I'm aware of it. But when I go into a party, I will walk out with your girlfriend.
See, there he goes. It's like, you know what? No, you won't.
Exactly. Yeah.
Not this decade.
I'd walk out with you. Walk out with my girlfriend and me.
Where are we going, Gene?
Yeah, Gene. We're gonna go listen to records.
I'm gonna fuck your girlfriend.
Just clueless about the whole thing.
I'll walk out with your girlfriend. Really?
And I'm walking out with both of you. Let's go to McDonald's.
Yeah.
With duct tape and a fucking gun, he'll walk out with a girlfriend.
The interview ended this way.
Just one more question before we wrap up. I would like to think that the personality you've presented on our show today is a persona that you've affected as a member of KISS, something that you do on stage and before the microphone, but that you're not nearly as obnoxious in the privacy of your own home or when you're having dinner with friends.
Fair enough. And I'd like to think that the boring lady who's talking to me now is a lot sexier and more interesting than the one who's doing NPR, you know, studious and reserved. And I bet you're a lot of fun at a party.
Well, we'll leave it at that. Gene Simmons, thanks so much.
I look forward to our meeting.
Bye-bye.
They're both right.
Yep.
Yeah.
They're both right there.
But she wasn't being shitty to him.
She wasn't. She was just doing who she normally... She was being herself, doing what
she hung in there.
Does.
Exactly.
I was always kind of impressed that she was able to...
Yeah, she hung in there. She would have given him a lot of leeway, I think, if he would have just been nicer at one point. I think she would have been very, very cordial.
He was just so hostile and so coiled spring. And like, you're wrong about that. It's like, I don't even think you guys are arguing, really.
Yeah, there was no need for an argument or some kind of...
It just sounded like he was feeling kind of bad about himself, and he told his publicist, put me on NPR so I could say a lot of cool things about me.
I'll talk about me.
Gene Simmons and Shannon Tweed have uncomfortable interviews because I guess they're promoting their new season.
Yeah.
So they go on Kathy Lee and Hoda.
Oh, great. Wow.
Those two dumb broads.
I just got to applaud when I hear those two names
those
put together.
Those two dumb broads Fantastic. That I'm obsessed with. And Gene and Shannon are uncomfortable. The ladies ask about a show clip where Shannon is mad at a picture taken of Gene with two women.
Well, it's tense in the studio. I got to tell you, folks.
Body language.
I've had you both on many, many times. We love you guys. But this concerns me. This is, you're in deep pookie, Gene.
Oh, kill me now. Oh.
So, Gene, what you just said, that you didn't know those girls except for from that photo?
Please.
What he means is he didn't know their name.
It was a business.
Oh please, Jeannie.
Dinner, and we always you should always have flowers on the table. Wasn't it a nice day today? Did you notice?
Hi.
Positioning my microphone.
Is that what you're doing?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Okay. Well, then what are you guys going to do about this? You're going to
get some... What am I going to do?
Yeah, yeah. Shannon, what's
he going to do?
One could answer that. Go ahead.
Well, it's clear that men...
Please don't lump yourself in with other men are good.
Oh, God. I'm so happy to be here.
There's some really good ones over there on that couch I'd like to get a hold of.
Have a mint.
Thanks.
God, I hate him. He's such a douche.
Well, I'm adjusting my microphone. It's slow speaking pattern that because he wants everyone to take every word he says as a golden nugget of wisdom. He's such an asshole.
And she sucks too.
And she stinks. The acting was horrible.
If this was a real thing where she wasn't in on it, why isn't she leaving?
Yeah, why isn't she leaving? Why is she on the show in the first place?
Is he that good of a catch?
Yeah, Kathy Lee's setup was great though, huh? Yeah. That was believable.
Yeah. Why isn't she leaving?
Yeah.
I'll talk for the broads out there. There's not a broad out there that would
with that shit.
With a Gene Simmons.
And where do they live? California? Mm-hmm. Look, you know what the laws are in California as far as not even being married? Just fucking palimony?
Oh, she would.
She could leave
walk away with
and take
shit.
Half of Kiss's shit.
Right.
Half of Kiss's shit. Fuck a prenup. Fuck everything. Because there ain't no prenup. She'd get half of Kiss's shit.
Do you think Gene is having sex with a lot of women? Or is this completely fake?
Well, he did have sex with that one. We saw that horrible video of him pumping away on just fucking
like
having
a
convulsion on a woman.
Like an old lion.
Oh, yeah. He's fucking like an old lion with his ass just going, the underslung ass, just humping her. It's a humping. The woman got a humping from Gene Simmons.
The uncomfortableness, because this got crazy yesterday.
Oh, I bet this got wow.
Shannon's fed up with Gene.
So we're going to see in this whole new series,
this relationship unraveling,
right? To this point.
Well,
did you have
pretty much unraveled.
Did you have a fling with those girls, or was it just a picture?
I've had a fling with many girls.
Did you?
We, if somebody, look, they're taking our photo right now, taken out of context.
No, they're just,
taken
no, that's out, just, taken that's out our of context. I've never seen you tongue-tied.
very good. I've never seen those two girls before until we...
You called them.
No, I didn't call them. Our people called them.
Uh-huh. What's the status right now of you guys?
Well, you'll see. I don't want to give away everything.
Right there.
Proves it's all fake.
Thank you. Good night. You'll see.
Because it's more important to get ratings for your TV show than talking about how your marriage might be in trouble. It's fucking bullshit.
If you're really angry.
Right.
You know, anytime there's been, throughout the years, whenever anger has popped up on this radio show between whatever members... of the show it was. And there has been some battles between. The argument has never stopped for the participants to go, and by the way, argument's going to continue after these words, so don't go away.
Sure.
You play it out because you're genuinely pissed and you have genuine emotion that you want to get out. That's so fucking fake. And I can't believe I have to actually say this, that it's fake. Well, but people, again, America is dumb.
Kathy Lee and Hoda should be the ones going, all right, come on.
Yeah,
this
come
is
on.
So
give it
stupid
up.
And
Stop
fake.
It. Stop it.
But instead they're like, I guess we're going to have to watch then.
Yeah. Well, tune in and see what happens between Gene and Shannon. Oh, boy.
Hope they have the show on at the Botox shop. Is there a Botox shop?
There should be.
Ted's. Botox.
Botox.
Shop.
It should be spelled Shoppy.
Two P's and an E.
P's and an E. Shoppy.
Everything, but not looking great.
It's not looking right.
Now,
well, you guys have kids.
My kids are in college. They're cooked. I'm done.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm done, as Andrew Dice Clay would say.
Nicholas graduated with honors from college. Oh. Sophie is now, as a matter of fact, driving
her little smart car all the way to Canada just to get away for a few days.
Mm-hmm. He held it together until they got to college.
Yeah. Yay!
A lot of couples do that.
Is driving... could I speak any slower? No. I'm Gene Simmons.
He's so hateable. He's so hateable.
Listen what I say. It's very important.
Fucking asshole he is. Jesus, I hate him.
What a stupid... Stupid Darth Vader hair.
It is.
Fucking asshole.
It does. It looks like a Darth Vader helmet.
What a fucking dick.
Oh, man.
He's got the worst hair.
That is horrible.
Way worse than Donald Trump.
It looks like pubes.
I don't know what it is.
It has the consistency of pubes. It's not like real hair. It is a helmet of like lint.
Mm-hmm.
His hair is like lint shaped into hair.
They need an angle for this new season. Yeah. He wants to rock. She's ready to roll.
Oh, I get it. He wants to rock. She's ready to roll. She's going to leave. Do we realize these are people in their 60s?
Right.
Fucking come on.
Right.
We're not talking youngsters here.
Right.
That are, whoa, he wants to party, does he? Gene wants to sit home, kick his feet up and watch TV,
Gene,
and she's content fucking being a housefrau.
Gene has never been about the rock.
No.
Sorry to the Kiss fans out there. He's never been about the rock.
Sorry, it's about the money.
It's always been about the money.
Yeah. He doesn't want a rock. And he's doing the rock fucking hand,
yeah.
the rock horns with his hand.
And she's got her arms folded.
And she's got her arms crossed. Uh-oh,
Don't cross her.
And he's like, I'm going to rock. And she's like, guess what I'm going to do.
Look
at me. I'm going to rock. I got my hair and my glasses, my sunglasses on. She's like, I'm folded. No, you're not. Shaggy. Your grandparents. Shut up. Oh, God.
And he didn't want to do our show, huh? Because I think we're one of the only shows that challenge him on this shit.
Yeah.
Then they went on Joy Behar. So
what the fuck happened there? I hope Joy at least called them out.
You'd like to think.
Oh, you would.
Because I think Joy is, you know, I saw her at the Pat Cooper roast, and man, does she have a potty mouth.
Oh, yeah.
And you've done her show.
Yeah.
So I hope she called them out on this because, all right, on Kathy and Hoda, they're obviously splitting up. So why would they now go and do another interview?
Yeah. Dumb. So they're going around together doing interviews about how they don't want to be together and you have to watch.
Yeah.
Stop it.
What's going on over there?
He's
a pig and I don't like it.
He's a pig?
And okay. I'm done.
You're finished with him? But you're not married, so you don't have to get a
I'm fucking.
Did she say I'm fucking?
Sound like she goes, I'm fucking.
This
is off the website, so.
Oh, you could have potty language.
What would have changed? Because, you know, this isn't Gene in a midlife crisis.
Oh,
Gene has always been this way.
Midlife crisis?
And she's always accepted it.
Yeah, so what's...
It wasn't like he was hiding anything from her ever.
No, they were supposed to... It was so such public knowledge that these two were in this open relationship. Whoa, look out! But yeah, what changed to make it... Now it's a part of the show that it's something bad happened.
What changed is the show needed a little pump.
You need a little boost.
A little boost.
Needed a little boost. People stopped caring after 5 seasons.
Oh,
exactly.
Really? And so somebody went to him and said, you know what would make people watch again? You know, get those numbers up? You guys officially start fucking fighting and talking about how it's over.
How you guys are splitting up so people, you know, because people genuinely have an affection for you two together. And if you split up, people are going to be like, no. Really? I don't think so. Oh, God, I hate Gene Simmons.
Oh, Chelsea Handler went all over Gene Simmons. Do we have that clip? Let me really quickly. Tom, go ahead. Buffalo.
Hit it, them.
Hey, good morning. That's what I was calling to tell you about was Chelsea. She was phenomenal with him. She was great.
Really?
Was it last night?
Good.
No. It was like, I think it was last Friday.
Shit.
I watched the DVR, so I don't know exactly. But in the past four days.
God, I missed that Buffalo or... Actually, it's a Western New York accent. I don't even know if you're from Buffalo, but I think you live in Buffalo.
I am.
You're from... Wow. Okay.
Wow.
I was here when you were here, Opie.
All right, right on.
I'm older than you.
Wow, 72?
No, I'm 33.
No, I meant the year,
so
dummy.
I'm a couple years older.
Yeah, just a couple years older. All right, brother. Thanks,
hey,
Tom.
Have a good day. Bye, guys.
Kind of missed that Western New York accent. Yeah, so Gene and Shannon talked to Joy about the show clip with the picture. Oh, so they're...
Same deal.
Holy shit. So that's the clip that they released to the media.
That's the whole thing that they based their promotional thing on. Could you imagine me and my ex-wife going around
right.
and saying, well, yeah, we're pretty mad at each other here. You trying to rape me over the rake me over the coals. Rape me. I love that, too. Could you imagine that?
No.
I can't either.
But do people realize this is fake?
No.
I think one of our bosses sent an email saying this is real. Come on.
No.
Oh, yeah.
No.
I might have deleted this.
Oh, wait. I probably
I have
it.
Deleted this.
I probably have it in the unread messages.
Let me see. I deleted mine. Do you have it?
Let me see. Oh, bup. Now, Danny Ross.
Does a news thing every
does
night.
Does news stories.
Right.
Every night he sends, he's got, you know, the teachers sending the kitty pics and the Montel partners with pot dispensary. All kinds of fun things we could talk about.
Right.
But then Steve Blatter decided he was going to pop in and maybe top off the list of stories.
Help with the show prep.
Help with the show prep.
Help with
There's
the
show prep.
There's
nothing wrong with that.
Not at all.
There's nothing wrong with that. And it's... Shannon Tweed walks out on Gene Simmons during taping of the Joy Behar show. And then there's a link to the clip, I guess. So he did. We are playing the clip, right?
Well, that was
so he helped out.
Well, you just blew the big get here.
Oh, shit.
Like
damn it.
I give a fuck.
Damn it.
You just blew it in.
Oh.
Hold on a second.
That is. She walks off. Oh, boy.
Dave in Texas. Dave.
Damn me.
Yeah, I didn't let you guys know, man. Covino and Rich completely fell for that bullshit.
Oh, no.
Man, they were just, it was awful.
Oh, man, I like those guys. We got to teach them a little more about this radio thing.
Radio biz that you got to call people out every so often.
You know how confident I am in the fact that this is fake?
Yeah.
I heard about this. I swear to you, I haven't even heard these clips yet.
No.
I don't need to. I just
don't
know.
Don't even have to. You know it's fake.
So I want to say that. That's how confident I am that what we're about to hear is completely fake.
Is fake.
It was awful to listen to.
All right, Dave. Thank you, sir. So let's get into this. Joy Behar.
What's going on over there?
I had
He's
a
pig, and I don't like it.
He's a pig?
Okay. And I'm done.
You're finished with him? But you're not married, so you don't have to get a divorce.
I have.
Isn't that good?
You're not married
no,
either.
No, that's good news. Right.
You're not married. No.
That's fucking... Couple things.
Yeah.
How much fucking Botox did she have? Because her mouth doesn't move anymore.
Yep.
She's talking through like a puppet or something. And secondly, you just explained California. It doesn't matter if you're married.
Doesn't matter.
Either way, Palimony. Gene Simmons would be fucked in this situation.
Fucked in his A's.
And Joy knows that, but you know, you're not married. But that doesn't matter in California.
And then why does he have to go, you're not married. I'm rubber, you're glue. Whatever I say.
Good.
You're not married
no,
either.
That's good news. Right.
You're not married.
No.
So it was a nice day today, didn't you think?
What?
He's
what,
got
what do you have,
nothing.
Two girls that you took a picture with while you were on the road?
Two?
Went, no.
Are you killing me right now? What do you mean two?
Well, we're out of time.
2,000?
What was the question? We went out to dinner. It was a business meeting.
You don't need to explain. It's not about that.
She was asking
me. It's not about that day.
It's about what?
The life.
What
the life.
You've been with him for 27 years.
I'm tired.
28.
I'm tired of
You're
it.
You're tired of the life?
Well, the kids went to college, and I'm tired of his life.
Which is?
That stuff. Stupid crap.
Yeah, see, she doesn't want to say
that. Stop.
20. So after 28 years of him going around saying that he gets to fuck whatever he wants, she's finally tired of
it. Now she's tired of it. Now she's fucking tired of it. again.
Why?
It's she's, fake.
She stayed in this fake fucking bullshit for the kids? Get out of here.
Oh, yeah, for the kids.
Get out of here.
We have an open relationship.
I get to do whatever I want.
I could be with whoever I want. If she doesn't like that, she can leave.
Because guys have a lot of sperm.
Men are different than women. If I may explain... No, don't interrupt me. if I may explain.
Oh, it just takes him forever to get those magical words out. Oh, is he the worst?
To this day, the greatest moment was when he put his hand on Danny's
hand when Danny was typing.
God forbid Danny was typing shit for the radio show.
Yes. Oh, perish the thought. Danny's typing. It's like in the background, a little of this. And fucking douchebag Gene didn't even fucking miss a beat.
Kiss will be getting a tour together.
And he just leans his hand over and puts it right on top of Danny's hand to make him stop typing.
Yeah.
While his majesty is fucking yapping about nothing.
Please find that clip.
Oh, it's classic.
We haven't played that in a while.
You just hear.
Right.
And then it just stops and Gene continues his dumb diatribe of bullshit.
We've always been fans of having the noise of the room when we broadcast.
I like the ambient sound of a radio show.
That's why you hear the door close every day.
Yeah, and mics squeak every so often. There you go.
That was on cue. The door just closed.
The door closes. Jimmy's farting. Farts. Whatever.
And a lot of serious broadcasters.
Yeah.
They want those type of microphones where if you're an inch off the mic, you can't hear anything.
Ow.
We hate that. We always hated that. And we kind of like that. All of a sudden, you might hear some typing in the background or something.
And
but not Gene.
It does go back to, I'll give Howard some props on that one. Remember years ago, you'd hear Fred just rattling the carts around when they used to use fucking carts?
Yeah.
I always thought that was kind of cool because it gave you kind of a mental image of what was going on in the studio.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't have to be just this
broadcaster on his microphone. Perish the thought, any ambient sound is coming from the background.
I think it's great to have little things going on, people yapping. And if I start doing a read, it took, I think, years to stop people from going, shh, shh.
Right.
It's like, I don't care if people are just kind of, you don't yapping hear it. Stuff. It's just a little background noise.
Yeah, I like that about our show.
Yeah.
I said it as far as my music goes and how we do radio. I call it having a little dirt.
Yeah.
I like a little dirt in my music.
A little dirt.
When you get into a band and then they go in that studio and make that over-the-top polish shit.
Pristine.
I fucking hate that. Yep. That's usually when I start, turning from liking a band.
Yeah. Man,
you hear a little...
A little dirt in there.
A little grittiness, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
A little dirt.
A little dirt.
Just a little.
I hear you.
Joy Behar continues with Shannon and Gene. Talk about doing the next five episodes of the show.
So let me try to understand this because I don't know what's going on here. It sounds like you have been together a long time. You have your philandering ways. Is that the
word
I'm hearing?
I like that
Is it
word.
True, Gene?
There have been.
There have been. Are there any now?
Not right now.
Not right this minute.
In the last, month?
But,
month?
In the last month.
Month, would you say?
No.
No.
Congratulations.
So she seems to have had
it. Could you pause this for a second?
I hate
these
this.
These two are dullards.
I hate
they
this.
They are fucking dullards. Joy Behar is fucking tap dancing. She's fucking sweating. She's tap dancing for her life here. She's the one talking. And then you get the overly important Gene... With his fucking wisdom. And then Shannon with one-word answers.
Mm-hmm.
And fucking... They're bore fests.
Right. And what, Gene goes and has sex with whoever he wants and then...
That's what I do.
And then he comes home and is like, oh boy, I'm going to be in a little trouble.
I could be in Dutch today.
Yes, Dutch.
Here.
No, you're not in any trouble. You're promoting a TV show with the same fucking act.
Gene, you're not in trouble. And Shannon, you don't give a fuck.
You don't care.
If this is even happening.
And poor Joy is fucking spinning plates and hula hooping.
Right.
To try to get this interview anywhere.
But don't you understand? Just having Gene on your show, man.
Just the name, Gene Simmons.
Just the
Simmons,
name.
It
doesn't matter.
The people.
It doesn't matter if he actually performs for you.
Fuck Gene Simmons in his asshole.
You're lucky just to have him on your show.
Right.
We were lucky to have him on our show over the years.
Congratulations.
So she seems to have had it.
Pretty much.
And yet you're on television in this reality show. It's in the can already?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's in the can.
How many more episodes after the one I just showed?
So she's had it, but she's out promoting the show.
She's still there. So obviously,
the show is
the show's
filmed,
done,
but they're going to promote it together.
Which means, aren't they still together?
Wouldn't she just go, you know what? Fuck you.
Yeah.
I'm not doing any promotion. This marriage is over. Yeah, we've already filmed this, so good luck with that.
So do you leave him in the show that's already filmed? Oh, yeah, yeah, I left him. So what are you doing here?
Right.
What the fuck are you doing here?
And to the dummies, what network is that?
A&E.
To the dummies at A&E, wouldn't it have worked better if it was just Gene and Gene tells everyone, yeah, man, she right. just refuses to do press. She is fucking
she
pissed, and
yeah.
I don't want to tell you what happens. You're gonna have to watch, but yeah. it's not good. But to have them both together after the show was taped to making believe that this marriage is over is a crock of shit. It's a crock of shit.
Oh God, I hate this.
Episodes after the one I just showed. No.
Well, I hope another five. They ordered another five after that.
They
I
did.
Can stand it.
And,
are you going to do the five, Shannon?
You might.
You might. All righty.
Can you talk, you fucking bitch?
You might.
Are you going to do it?
I might.
Why would you? I thought you said you were fed up.
How about elaborating on the fact that you might or might not, or just say something?
Now you know why she, her movie career was... horrible,
oh, God.
Like, B-movies or whatever
she
it was.
Fucking spread her fucking legs in Playboy or whatever. And that's what she's known for.
But
fuck her.
She tried to be an actress, and now we know why she never got any real roles.
Oh, God. Poor Joy had to deal with that. You might. Joy even repeated, you might. Like, could you help me out here? Help me out here, Hendry. I'm trying to conduct an interview here.
Go to CNN. Please.
Yeah.
CNN, thank you, Scott S. from Quakertown. He's reliable.
Quakertown.
One of the reliable ones. Stories on the front page of CNN, like this is real.
Stop.
Why? Why does the media go along with this?
Are you kidding? It would be like fucking putting wrestling in the sports section. All due respect.
Well, they kind of...
all due respect.
They kind of do now.
Do they?
Yeah, they
the
do.
Sports. Is it in the sports section?
Yes, it is.
Because sports section is very close to the entertainment section, and it being sports entertainment.
Sports entertainment section.
Sports entertainment section.
It's on the
one
border.
Page.
It's on the border.
It is
it's
on
that
the
page
border.
That goes from sports to entertainment.
Yeah, you turn the page, and you see what's on TV, and you know the reviews of the new shows, and then you flip one back, and you see what the Mets did.
If it's not on CNN.com, I'm going to have to knock Scott S. from Quaker down.
Someone's
Quaker
blocked.
Town down a notch.
Someone's going to get blocked.
Yes.
I'll use my computer because I think it's a little faster than yours.
Well, here's computer. The clip that everyone's talking about today. Finally, we get to this.
In those days, you know, Gene Simmons was on the show. Or I've heard this before from him anyway. He claims that he had sex with 5,000 women. Do you believe that?
At the same time?
No.
Oh.
If that's true, wouldn't he be in traction at this point?
Yeah.
How's your back, Gene?
my back is good. My schmeckle, not so much.
That's very nice of you to joke about.
It's a joke. Where are you going? What are
so
you doing?
So rude.
She's
so
done
rude.
With you.
It's so rude for you to joke about it.
I was just joking because she's a comedian.
Here, she's back on. It suits you.
Thanks for the question.
I'm sorry. You're blaming it on me? Don't put this on me. This
well,
is all yours.
You did the entire setup. Please come back here. Well, I'm trying to make you feel a little more comfortable.
So it's possible that she's done with you, Jane. How do you feel about it?
Well, I hope not.
You hope not.
Please come back.
Please come back.
Please come back.
Yeah, there's a guy that cares about his woman, right?
I hope not. Poor Joy's like put in the middle where she's got to be part of a work.
Right.
Part of a fucking angle.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
If he cared about her, wouldn't he just like maybe get up now and... You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
Instead well, of like, please come back.
Thank you for the question.
Please come back.
Boys.
Sort of has a commitment thing going on.
Will you come back?
I don't see it.
Are you coming back?
Please come back.
Please come back.
Shannon, you want to come back?
I don't really.
She doesn't. She's mad. She's mad.
I'm tired.
Good setup, Joyce.
Don't blame me for this.
Well, you're...
I thought that that's what we were talking about.
We're going to talk about our new season.
See, you know, here's the problem with a person in my position. A lot of these reality shows, are, you know, they're bullshit. I don't know if it's true or not. So I thought that this is a game. Now it turns out that it's really true.
No, this is...
I really thought this was part of
No, this is actually happening to us.
The so-called reality show shtick.
Yeah, she's hinting at it. Oh, she should have unloaded, though.
Yeah, she should have said this is
bullshit. She's responsible, too, to a point.
She helped the work.
Yeah.
By saying what she said at the end there.
Yeah.
Making it believable for people that were on the fence. Joy, you know it's a work.
Or she could be doing the whole, hey, most of these are bullshit. You know, like, hey, it's bullshit.
I think it's bullshit.
Yeah, I don't know.
Huh?
I would like to think Joy is not part of a work like that.
Well, maybe
she's smart enough to know that's not fucking real. Come on. Come on.
You got to think.
Yeah, you would think. God, that's awful. Oh, the sex man.
Oh, good.
Has the Danny clip where Gene fucking placed his hand over Danny's hands for typing during his fucking amazing speech that he was giving.
Wasn't there a shushing, too?
Was there a shush? I'm talking here, and you're typing things.
Are we done with the Joy thing? What do you think there?
Yeah.
Come on, it's fake.
Yeah, it's completely fake. Joy knows it's fake.
That's
she stepped in and helped them out, I guess. Whatever.
Maybe she bought into it.
I don't think she bought into it.
You don't think she bought?
No.
Oh, that's even worse.
I think she helped these two out. They're on her show. She's like,
I'll go with it.
Yeah, we obviously would fucking, Gene would be sitting there. I swear to you. I fucking swear to you. If Gene was here today with Shannon at this very moment trying to sell this shit, I would be unloading on them both saying stop.
Of course.
Just stop it right now and fess up that this is a complete show angle.
Hey, man. They accomplished what they wanted. We're talking about it. Everyone else is talking about it.
Yeah.
That's the angle they're taking for the latest season of their show.
What about the fact that it's complete horse shite?
I think so. I know so.
I know so.
I'm not even going to say think.
No.
I know so. This is all bullshit.
It's a bunch of crap.
And I bet you even the season ends with her like packing her bags or something.
And him dramatically going, don't go.
Don't go.
Don't go.
I love
don't
you.
Go.
I will change my ways.
I will change my ways.
But then all of a sudden it'll just be the credits and they're like, oh God, now we're going to have to wait for the next season to find out what happens here.
What? Are you leaving? I'm leaving. Don't go.
Don't go.
I'm going. Please don't leave. I'm leaving. Don't go. It's just for fucking 10 minutes. Them just going back and forth with their boar speak. Oh, God, no.
Come on, guys. Come on. What are you doing? What are you doing?
I know. It stinks.
I think we can finally break, huh?
Yeah, I got to eat my sandwich.
Oh, no, we got the Danny clip.
All right, Danny clip.
The sex man has it?
Sex man's got it.
Why don't we listen to this?
Sex man. Oh, Jiminy Cricket.
This is Gene Simmons on our show.
Yes.
And he really was bothered by Danny just doing a little typing in the background. Danny obviously doing something for the show.
Yeah.
Trying to pump up the show that day.
Typing.
And Gene was like, how dare you?
Type while I'm talking.
Don't do that. This is how it went down.
In Europe, you actually had women who were walking around the courts of Europe and actually not making noise while I'm talking. Like this guy's on the side going like...
Danny was typing.
Danny was looking something up on the internet.
Yeah. Why are you so uptight?
No, I just want to control everything.
It's just a keyboard.
I know, but just a keyboard to you means he's getting in the way of me.
He's looking up stuff for the show.
Okay.
He's not like checking his
flies,
email.
Flies buzzing
you
around your head don't bother me. They bother me.
What? Noises bother you?
Well...
Does that really bother you?
At that point, I was trying to gather my thoughts and that thing right there, I think that made me wander a little bit. Well, how come you don't do that when he's talking? Go ahead.
I certainly do.
Oh, my God. All sorts of stuff happens
well,
while
you let him
do the show.
My
yeah,
dogs,
it doesn't bother
the
us.
The dogs at my home don't bark because they're not allowed to. You
dick.
Allow them to shit on your carpet? Yeah, it's your thing.
His dogs don't bark because he doesn't allow them to?
I don't allow them to.
Can you imagine this guy's your father?
Don't go.
I hear he raised two really, really good kids, but still. At what price? At what price?
Fuck him.
Fuck him.
Fuck him and his whole family.
Can we get that out there, please? Get the PR department on that one.
Yeah,
that's our quote.
Work
today.
That angle. Fuck Gene Simmons and his whole fucking family.
That's our quote today. That's what we think.
Is this Kiss?
Yeah.
Kiss.
Kiss made an appearance on the
Country Music, right?
Country Music Awards last night. They looked very out of place. I was forced to watch that crap because I agreed to live tweet it.
Oh.
But
did they promote me on that? Because I wasn't involved with that. Why would they have promoted me?
I think so.
I'm hoping that's a mistake.
I think in the email or something they said that you were going to live tweet, Ant was going to live tweet. I thought I was in good company, so I'm like, all right, I'll live tweet. And I don't see any of you guys.
I was working.
I spent 8 hours.
I didn't see any of you guys.
8 hours marathoning Game of Thrones.
Game of Thrones.
Isn't it great?
Fucking great.
Oh.
Oh, Gene
Simmons. I'm opening up Rockin' Brews Restaurant.
What? What is that?
Gene Simmons is opening up a restaurant.
Where?
Oh, boy. Rockin' Brews.
I had to watch the Country Music Awards.
Oh, God. There
Question
he is.
For Jimmy.
Sure.
So, Gene Simmons and Paul Stanley go
Yay!
Up there.
Oh, sorry.
To give out an award, whatever. They looked very out of place. But then you didn't have the Ace Frehley and the Peter Criss. You had two guys looking really just stupid up there because it was obvious they...
Tommy Thayer, I think, is a guitarist, and I believe it's Eric Singer is the drummer.
And both those guys have worn the makeup in the past.
Oh, sure.
Yeah, but they looked really out of place. Oh, like, God. They are obviously barely part of the band.
I would prefer that they had different kind of character. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I would prefer that just because I don't need to have it look like it looked in 1976. It's a different band now.
Right.
Like, you know what I mean? It's like, look, Ace and Peter left. What are you going to do? They're gone.
Right.
So you got two other guys. I would prefer to just have them, because I don't need to look at it and go, wow, it's the visual. Because that's what the Gene's point is. Like, hey, look, man, this is the way that people like to see the band. It's what they like to watch. I would prefer to see them in different characters. That's all.
Oh.
Can he fix his hair?
It's black Gene's, cotton candy.
Gene Simmons' hair has... It just has drove me nuts for years.
Just all
what is
up.
It?
Looks dead.
It looks dead. He has dead hair on his
yes,
head.
Dead hair on my head. It's a new restaurant. I've secretly trademarked the word hamburger, so I'll be suing anybody that uses the word hamburger like they do in my restaurant.
I really? Eagerly look forward to going to Gene's restaurant and having
God.
A burger, having I'm, a kiss, some kiss fries.
Get a fucking yeah.
Could Thank I, you, Gene.
Could I have the pompous pork rib? And could I have the ridiculous ribs?
No.
Could I have the shithead shake? And
no, I'd say let me have the Star Child special, please, with a side of demon fries.
Oh God,
that's what I would have.
Oh,
probably
really?
A hamburger shaped like a star. I'm going to enjoy my Kiss burger.
A star shot.
Yay!
Oh, God. And if you could eat the hot dog in one piece like Paul does, just put it down your throat, you get it to eat. You get it free.
I will not stand for this talk of my childhood heroes.
I know, Jimmy. Aw.
Paul Stanley had a jelly belly during the Country Music Awards.
Did it really?
It's like start wearing a one piece. He has his costume where the belly shows. I guess back in the 70s, yeah. He might have been in shape to pull that off. Now it's just a jelly belly.
Let me see the country music.
An extremely hairy jelly belly.
Yeah, he is a kind of a bear.
Mm. Yes, we have the Gene, the Simmons hair pasta, which is, we don't even boil it. It's just ramen noodles without any water. Very dry. See? Get it?
Gino. I will not support any mockery of
Why?
The Gene Simmons restaurant.
Oh.
My childhood heroes. Oh. I will go and have myself a nice Kiss shake. It's four delicious ice creams.
Oh.
One for each member of the band.
Oh, great.
I'll have the you're going to try to fuck my girlfriend chicken.
Jesus Christ.
Fuck this guy.
Ugh.
Sounds like Jimmy might be doing something with Kiss or Gene Simmons in the near future.
No, no, not at all. I just think that Ant's being very selfish, and it's like any girl I've ever dated.
Enough with this guy.
It's the rule. If anybody in the original four lineup of Kiss wants to fuck you, give it up. If Ozzy wants to fuck you, he is also allowed to kill you after. Those are my rules for chicks.
Remember how he made fun of everyone that got married or is in a long-term relationship, and then this dummy turns around and gets married?
Stop.
Shut up.
Oh, that's funny. Coming from Connecticut, the stop your typing steak.
That's right.
Told Danny to
Gene
stop.
Gene doesn't like being interrupted.
Stop his typing.
As he shouldn't.
Can I have the I'm going to shush you fries?
Yeah. Oh, enough of
that's
you.
That's right.
That's what you need. Gene Simmons shushing
off.
You.
That's right.
Rock and Brew restaurant designed to capture excitement of concerts. It's going to be all the excitement of a concert. Oh, trying to fucking eat in peace. You're talking to somebody and a giant KISS fucking million watts of lights light up over your table.
Sure. You eat your chicken pot pie, you cut into it, and there's a little radio in it, and they go, I want to rock and roll out of your pot pie.
Sounds dangerous.
I would enjoy that quite a bit, actually.
I don't know anything about this restaurant, but I would assume it's going to be hot waitresses and maybe KISS makeup.
Dressed in KISS makeup?
There would have to be.
It's actually a good idea. I didn't even think
it would have to be some kind of
on
a
their
KISS
skin, though.
It would have to be some kind of KISS theme
yeah.
to work. It can't just be a regular restaurant that he's... that he's financing.
Where is it opening? Where does it, I need to know where this will be.
KISS and Motley Crue this summer, though.
Yeah, yeah, it's a good tour.
Damn.
I would love to meet the original four KISS together, man. It is a disgrace they're not in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. I mean, it's just wrong.
We had three out of the four, right? I don't think Peter Criss was there that famous day at NAW.
Let's see, Rock and Brew. El Segundo?
I met them with Peter, but with Tommy.
El Segundo!
He's been with them a while, Tommy, there.
We've never met Peter Criss, I don't think.
I've met him a couple times. I'd love to interview him especially after the breast cancer. But him, because you look at Ace. Ace is a fucking cool dude, man. I mean, they're just not business guys.
Oh my God! Yeah, I guess is it El Segundo, California?
Yeah.
Where's that?
I don't know, but
it's near M Segundo.
Fred Sammer used to talk about it all the time. Going to El Segundo.
How do you remember that?
I don't know. I just remember that.
Where is it in relation to
LA? Another one is set to open in the Los Angeles International Airport later this year. Well, you could go to that one, Jimmy.
Yeah, I got some stuff in LA, so I'll go. Mm-hmm. Bing, boom.
Simmons.
We got our first flying car. Makes debut at New York Auto Show.
I hate that, though, because it's a plane. Yeah. Flying car should be a car that flies. That's a driving plane.
Yeah, I guess
it's not
you're
a
right.
flying car. It's a driving plane.
I guess you're right.
I don't want a vehicle... that if it gets clipped in a fender bender, you can't fly it. You know, if somebody hits that wing as you're driving it as a car, you can't then open it up and fly it.
They should make a rule that the wings don't fold in if you have a flying car.
So you got to drive it down the highway with fucking
you got to figure out if people can allow you to take up two lanes for your flying
Could
car.
Could I get in here? Right. Could I get in here?
I'm going to need all three lanes.
Trying to edge your wing in front of a truck.
Little help here, please.
Yeah, I don't buy that.
Should we break and eat?
Yeah, let's eat, motherfucker.
I want to have my
yes,
my destroyer eggs.
Destroyer eggs?
Yeah.
That's
I'm
going to
have my KISS destroyer eggs.
Oh, good.
Yeah, wonderful.
That's fantastic.
Have a nice KISS burger, some bacon.
I'm sure they'll be called things like...
Probably shaped like tongues, the bacon.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I bet.
Hanging out like it's fucking like rocking in front of you.
Oh, how douchey.
No.
Oh, Gene.
It's going to be good.
Gene's great.
Gene's a douche.
He's great, isn't he? He's wonderful.
Fuck yeah, man.
Yeah, Detroit Rock City burgers and
yeah.
Oh yeah. That'll be $70 for a burger.
He's great.
I need to make money too.
Love him. Sam talked to is he an arch nemesis or is he a what would you call Gene Simmons?
Douchebag?
Besides an asshole.
Yeah, asshole shithead.
How Anthony feels about him, but I guess I do now.
Cum guzzler.
Ant certainly doesn't like him more than me, but I don't like him either, man. He's just an idiot.
I think he's funny.
He's so full of himself.
He still hasn't gotten over the distraction thing, by the way. Last time he was in here when he put his hand over Danny's hand because
what?
He was typing while he was talking.
Yeah.
Yesterday when I was talking to him, his guy and Spencer the talent booker would just like kind of whisper something. And I couldn't even hear them in my headphones, but Gene Simmons, every single time, if they whispered while he was talking, would make reference to the fact that there was whispering or coughing or whatever it was going on in the studio while he was speaking.
Oh, who cares? He's so important. Every word has to be heard without the click-clack of a fucking keyboard.
Yeah.
He's famous because he wore clown makeup. Shut the fuck up.
You wore wacky clown makeup.
Right.
And sang a few forgettable songs.
Goofy, catchy songs. Shut up.
You know, I didn't realize until I went to see KISS that time how few fucking songs they really have that I knew.
Really?
It was like three songs.
Rock and Roll All Night?
Yeah. That one fucking, like, Beth, which isn't even really a fucking KISS song.
And
Strutter?
No, not really. Not so much.
No.
We know it, but not
they
so
all.
Much.
It's like you think like they have a bunch of songs, but it was just no, they don't.
Let's call them
Shout
a one
it out loud.
We're gonna call them a one hit wonder.
One hit wonder.
Detroit
Kiss,
Rock City.
Kiss, one hit wonder. Sorry.
One hit wonder.
Beth.
Yeah, well, that was like.
And Gene's pissed off that he had nothing to do with that song, by the way.
Gene, how could I capitalize
on Beth?
Remember? Do we have that break?
I don't know if we just have it at our fingertips.
He twisted and said, well, actually.
Actually, I was the one that came up with the name Beth.
Before that, it was going to be Gene.
It was going to be Gene.
Shut up.
And it didn't rhyme, so I said, let's try Beth.
So was it?
Dick bag.
No, it wasn't.
And of course, Dr. Gay. That's right.
That song, but right. That's like a, you know, niche
Dr.
song.
Dr. Gay.
Jimmy, you might want to take the next 10 minutes off. We're trashing one of your heroes again.
Who?
Gene Simmons.
Gene, of course.
Why? What happened?
Sam got to finally talk to him about the incident.
Oh, he was here.
Yeah, him and Shannon Tweed Simmons.
Yesterday?
Yesterday.
Oh, I was taping yesterday. Okay,
why were they here?
Well, I'm promoting my family jewels.
That's right.
What I'm going to do is act like I'm angry about something, and then it gets resolved.
Really? Is that it? His reality show's coming back.
Did he announce that he's the biggest hypocrite going? Where he laughed at everybody about being married?
The new thing now is
he would go around the room. You married, and then if you said yes, he would laugh and go, "You're the stupidest person alive." And then in the end, he ends up getting married.
The new thing now is Shannon's mad at him because she found out he was cheating on her, especially after the internet sex tape.
Ooh,
came out.
Look out! But they're married.
They're
now,
wild.
Right?
Now they're married too. They are wild.
Yeah, I can't get into that show. So you got to talk to Gene
and Shannon.
Oh, really? She had to come along.
Yeah, I was glad she was there, though.
I like Shannon Tweed.
How did she look up close with all that plastic surgery?
Oh, man. She still looks good.
Be honest.
She a wreck. Be
honest.
I've always thought she looked good.
She's a little long in the tooth, as
I mean,
she's
for an older woman. She's sexy.
She used to be really good looking, but she had too much plastic surgery. Some of these broads have too much surgery.
Yeah.
She didn't look actually overdone in person. She's older. I wouldn't, you know, she's not in my age range.
Gene Simmons had way too much fucking plastic surgery, too.
Well, Gene Simmons is not...
Gene
Simmons
like?
Is a character.
Just had my eyes done. That's all I had done were my eyes. Oh, yeah.
Looks like he's wearing a mask.
It really does.
Nothing moves on his face.
No.
How'd he look?
He has sunglasses on, but, you know, his hair looks ridiculous. And
but his hair looks ridiculous. Yeah, that's
like,
coming from you.
Yeah.
No, but wow. at least it still looks like hair. On Gene Simmons, it's the consistency of, like, cotton candy.
It looks like dirty cotton candy.
Horrible. Did you have him on the after show?
No. I did. I taped him for the Sunday show. I'm going to air it on Sunday.
I'm bummed that I wanted them on my Boneyard show.
Really?
What time did you talk to him?
It was probably 12:30. Oh, okay.
Was he nice to you?
Yeah, it was a great interview.
Yeah, great.
Great, huh?
Great.
I enjoyed my time with him.
Of course, saying great.
I always have too.
Of course, everything you do is great, right?
No, not everything. But this I mean, compared to my other interviews, I'm very happy with
this
one.
They're all great.
Yeah.
I don't know if they're all great.
Everything you do is great.
I was listening to the after show yesterday as I was driving home.
That's great.
I can't remember one thing.
Well, Bob Kelly and Joe DeRosa were on.
Oh, right,
that's why. Don't bring them down. Why would you say such terrible things about
Bob
and Joe?
Because I just equate it to the show. It was so different. It wasn't the after show. Usually, you know, it's Troy Kwan comes in, you know, you bash E-Rock a little. E-Rock tries to sound like he's your co-host, failing miserably.
Did you find what I wanted you to find, E-Rock?
Yes, I did.
His shoes.
His shoes.
You know, it's hard to find.
Yeah, I know. I understand. And I agree.
He was so dejected that you remembered that you asked for it.
What is it? His fuck up?
When he tried to slam you and he had you. He had you. And
he God. Oh, can we hear this?
Yeah, me bad.
I want to hear this.
It passed me by, but someone goes, this is the most workout E-Rock has gotten in years.
Do you think
you've done that joke as many times as you've done this
joke? E-Rock.
As met a few of thoughts.
As met times as Frank Gaga Hamana.
Wow.
Well, here's Sam talking to Gene about the incident.
Yeah. What's going on between you and Anthony from Opie and Anthony? There was some rivalry, and you haven't been back on the show in a couple years at this point.
I'll go on. I have no idea.
You don't have anything going on with them?
I don't even know who he is. Which one is? I know Opie and Anthony, but I don't know who this guy is.
Well, I think it was his last time he came on is when he was dating the weather girl from Channel 11.
Oh, is that somebody you dated?
No, he didn't date her, but he made some kind of like, you know, remarks about her, and Anthony didn't realize that you had seen her earlier in the day.
I have no idea. Happy to go on the show. No.
You would be.
Somebody you slept.
Not that I know of.
I don't believe that he slept with her, but I wasn't present in the moment, so.
He was trying.
No, happy to go. Is this an invitation to be on the show?
Well, I'd have to ask them, but I would love to see you back
no.
on.
No.
Okay.
Here's the A&E guy. That's
why Barry. Why did he have a problem with it?
Well, what happened was Gene said something, you know, jokingly about, you know, stealing his girlfriend or something.
Wasn't a joke.
Ant took it as a joke.
Is that the girlfriend?
As it was intended. Ant didn't realize that earlier in the day, Gene had been on Channel 11 and had talked to Jill Nicolini, the traffic girl.
And that is his
and
girl.
Knew who Anthony's girlfriend was at the time oh. when he said it. You know what I mean? So I.
Did you know?
Not a I don't even know what we're talking about, but I'd okay. be happy to talk to anybody about it. Sure.
Okay, good. Well, I wanted to send that information.
Which
their
one
way.
Is Opie, the short
Gene,
one or the
Gene
tall
Gene hit
one?
On all women and probably didn't know that was his girlfriend.
Not a clue.
That's fair.
My guess.
Opie's the blonde one, and Anthony's the one who looks Italian.
Which one's the taller one? Because they both stand next. Oh, the Italian guy. Yes.
Right, Anthony.
So which one's the one that's angry?
Well, I believe at one point, I don't know if he's still angry. He's probably gotten over it, but.
No.
The Italian one?
Anthony, the Italian one.
No.
Yeah. He's, okay. I mean, I'm sure he's over it at this point. No, but
Anthony.
No.
You're not over it?
I do believe that he doesn't remember the incident, though. Yeah, oh, you should well, have him on and hash it out.
I'm a very important, busy man. Many things happen right. in my life where I can't remember things like that.
But he knew who was who. But when he started doing the I don't know who's who
but
thing.
You didn't explain the incident properly.
No.
Well, I mean, I didn't want
to. You're trying to be respectful in front of Shannon, so you didn't embarrass her. Right.
Right. I didn't, yeah. Fuck that.
Oh, fuck that.
Plus, I didn't
explain.
Go, hey.
I would explain the incident.
I didn't want to completely speak for Anthony.
I say you get him in here and hash it out.
He absolutely hit on Jill Nicolini.
He
that
might
day.
Apologize to you. You know, it's
he was hitting on her. She had said because she knew he was coming over here after. She had said that, oh yeah, you're going to be doing my boyfriend's show after this. And he's like, oh, what's that? What's that? Oh, Opie and Anthony. It's Anthony. It's my boyfriend. She said this. And he's like, oh, well, why don't we go out tonight? I'll take you to dinner and fuck you. And so, and then he, like, pinned her against the wall in the office. And she's like, you know, actually had to get help from some of the fucking people around the office. Yes.
Are you exaggerating
like,
this?
No. Because right. I remember all the good. Other news people saying to her, like, are you okay? Like, it was that fucking, like, blatant. And then he came over to do our show. And he tried to make it seem like nothing had happened, and he was taunting me with it. He was joking, knowing what he had done earlier, and thinking that he had made this big conquest. My cock.
But see, I can't go into it with that amount of detail because I'm not you. You got to have him on and be like, "Fuck you, dude."
You could say that again.
You know,
you should have done
him.
It.
Yes,
you should have done it, Sam.
I don't know.
I can't. I can't speak.
I think
for...
we should have him on. I think Ant should fucking. I don't want to see Gene get beat up, but I think Ant.
Why
Ant
would I? You know why? You know why? No, because he. I know it would happen. He'd come in. I'd try to explain it, and he'd be like, "Going, I don't even know what this is." But let me tell you, I have a new book out that I want to be. And it would just turn into a fucking Gene Simmons plug fest, and nothing would get resolved.
And I would help him plug.
Oh, of course you would. Look, I know you love him, Jimmy, I love you.
I know,
but I can't fucking stand that cocksucker.
I say no way.
Ugh,
I'm done with that.
I mean,
asshole.
If I thought we would actually have a conversation about it, I'd be fine. Right. But he wouldn't be. He wouldn't fucking entertain it.
I'll bet he would apologize.
He probably would, and that would like defuse the whole thing, and then he'd start plugging.
Plus, I spent like the first 15 minutes before that question asking him about Shannon finding out that he was cheating on her for years. So the and vibe in the room was already there.
And he would apologize, but it would be like, well, I'm very sorry if you were upset by that. Which isn't an apology.
If
like,
you were.
Oh, I don't remember were. It, but if you're still upset about something that happened years ago, I would apologize.
Did you tell him that I'm still a fan?
I didn't mention your name. I didn't want even for you to be associated with that at all.
Thank you, Sam. Good
any,
call.
Any negative,
good call.
You know.
Enough of him. Sam. Then he had this to say.
What does Opie and Tony? What does Opie and Tony think about Opie and?
Oh, you know their names.
Anthony. Oh,
you know their names.
Very bright.
You, I know what you're doing. You know their names.
You're very bright.
Wow.
And good looking too.
Gene,
you are going to be popular in jail. I'm telling you this.
I'm not going to jail anytime soon.
Oh, okay.
Looks like he wants to fuck you.
Maybe he does.
Let him.
It's Gene Simmons.
Fucking send God of Thunder. Open your fucking asshole for him. What are you doing? Teasing Gene.
I like Gene Simmons.
Me and you both.
I think he's hilarious. I don't like
I'm
what he did
hilarious.
To you.
Listen to how hilarious I am.
Two Jews walk into a bar. It was me and another Jew.
Right, we get it. Clown makeup guy. I like fucking clown makeup and big shoes. And two hit songs.
Had more than
fuck Gene Simmons.
Rock and roll all night and party every day.
Come on.
We're giving him two hit songs, Sam.
Strutter was a hit.
Nope.
Rock and roll all night and party every day.
Detroit Rock City.
Detroit Rock City.
Nope.
That's a big song.
Beth. And that's
Beth was a massive hit.
And he came up with the name for that song.
Yeah, how'd it go? Because he said that it was...
Well, I mean,
the name of the
song.
Girl was different. He's like, it's not going to work. We got to change this to Beth.
Well, I'll come up with a name for the song, and I'll give you full credit.
How you could see him saying that, right?
Right.
No.
Right. No.
Shout it out loud.
Shout it, shout it, shout it out loud.
You've got to have a party.
Yeah. We're doing a duet.
We sure are.
Dr. Love.
Yeah, fucking great
Dr.
tune.
Gay.
Yeah.
They call him
Dr. Gay.
Yes.
Dr. Gay.
Yeah.
How we doing?
My voice is still kind of fucked.
I like Kiss.
I love that he did fucking, he did Great Expectations, which was a very good song.
Yeah?
Yeah. Off of Destroyer.
Oh, I kind of like his sex tape.
What'd you say? He fucks like an old lion.
It looks like an old lion on the Serengeti. When you see an old lion fucking, and they got the underslung ass, and he's just going, that's how Gene was fucking, like an old lion.
Palmer Square says it was Beck.
What?
Beth, oh,
like, was it Beck? As in Becky?
As in Becky? I think it was. He said it was.
It was Beck. I hear you calling, and Gene said
Beck? No.
And Gene goes, no, it's not going to work.
Everyone's going to think you're in love with Jeff Beck. No.
And then he changed it to Beth, and that's why it's a hit. That's the only reason that song is a hit.
Why don't you come to my hotel and we'll fuck?
Didn't say that.
No.
My favorite part of this whole scenario is that I said Ant might be over it because I wanted to give you the option of like. No, I don't want him to think it still bothers me, but you immediately went, nope!
No! Not over it. Never over it.
Good for you.
Fuck him.
I just want to do Kiss songs now.
No.
All day.
Kiss
no.
is a good band.
They're fucking great.
No.
Making Love. Fucking Take Me.
Yeah.
Paul Stanley songs, but.
And it has nothing to do with Jill either. Like, I could give a shit.
You just hate that fucking guy.
He was trying to fuck me over.
He was alpha mailing you.
He was trying to alpha male and fucking cuck me.
In your house.
In my fucking house. Exactly. In my fucking house, he was trying to fuck me over like that and make me look the fool.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't going to take that.
You know what? In that moment, he did because you didn't know the scenario.
I didn't know the scenario, so I'm fucking joking around with him, and he's looking at me like, oh, I had your chick pinned against the fucking wall in the studios of Pix 11.
That would bother me.
It did bother me.
I mean, if she didn't fuck him.
Oh.
It would bother me. If my girl didn't fuck Gene, I'd be very angry at her.
Were you mad when Gene didn't share your banana?
Oh, God. I even got about that one.
That was so uncomfortable.
I was.
You got that clip.
We can share it if you want.
Yeah. Share it if you want. Oh,
I know.
This is almost a worst of today.
We did this bit
as well, but
this
fuck
is
it.
So
you got
douchey,
that clip.
It is very douchey.
Oh,
yes,
no.
It is.
What? He wanted a little piece of your banana because
sure.
He was a little hungry.
No, he wanted the banana. He was like, "Are you going to eat that?" And Jim was like, "No, you could have it. Actually, we could share it if you want."
Did I say that?
Yeah.
You know what? So Jimmy could say like later on at some point, he'd be like, "You know, no, I shared a banana with Gene Simmons."
Dude, if he would have eaten one, and I would have eaten the other until our lips met.
Do you have that banana peel somewhere?
No.
You sure?
I do not know. I don't save stuff like that.
Oh, that is great.
E-Rock found the clip.
How was it? I got to because, you know, roasting Gene was, you know, you like.
Can I take a bite?
Sure, you can have the whole thing. I'll actually share it with you if you want.
Just wanting that connection.
Yeah.
You got a personal touch.
I'll actually share it with you if you want.
Like, he was like, okay, I'll compromise and take the whole thing, but I'd really rather share it with you.
I'll share it with you if you want.
What am I going to say? When the God of Thunder wants some banana, you give him some.
God of Thunder.
Have some banana, buddy.
The God of Thunder.
That's great.
Oh, that is so
I'd love
good.
To share a banana with Gene.
Would you?
Yes. How many people get to share a banana with their childhood hero?
Not many.
True. You don't get to.
No. Would you get Gene Simmons' autograph tattooed on?
No. I've got them to sign everything I want them to sign.
You would do an Aussie tattoo, though.
No, I wouldn't do any of that at this point. But I got to slam Gene in a roast. That was great.
Yeah.
Fucking really smashed
him. Why are you touching yourself?
I got a fucking half a rod.
You got a rod again?
A half a rod.
Why? Stand
up. Let's went away.
He's talking about Gene Simmons.
It went away.
You were really... Oh, yeah, okay.
It's a little...
You were really tenting yesterday.
I know.
Holy shit.
Why
he stood
were you
up
yesterday?
And we weren't even talking about anything really sexual at that point. When you stood up and, like, just had the big fucking rod.
Well, why were you tenting, Jimmy?
I don't remember.
No?
It just happens. Sometimes the seat feels good on my hoodie.
While the Gene Simmons clip was on, Jim looked at me and pointed at his crotch.
Yeah, I pointed at my penis. It was real. And it jumped a little.
Why do you need people to know?
That's just silly.
I don't understand that part.
It's just a practical joke.
Yeah. Just a couple guys goofing saying
it's
all red face.
Just stand up and point at his dick. And it'll just be poking out. Hilarious.
Why not?
Drew, why don't you take us back to break? Because we went way too long that first break.
Ooh.
So right. Water under the bridge with Gene Simmons, all good?
Yeah.
No.
What?
Fuck him.
Oh.
Fuck him.
Sorry.
You spit blood and fucking breathe. Firehouse? Come on, man. Not even for Don Kirshner's rock concert, Firehouse?
One hit wonder.
No, many hits.
We'll give him two. We'll give him two.
Those fucking Dragon Boots.
They're one of the biggest bands of all time.
I went to the Kiss show and I realized how few songs I really even knew.
No when did you go?
I don't know.
10
like
years
last
ago.
Time they were. Was that like 10 years
probably
ago?
Probably at this point.
Jesus Christ. Last time they were at the Garden? No.
That's oh, wow. Probably 10 years
that's
ago.
That's probably 2002 or 3. That's where I met them.
What about I Was Made for Loving You? That's a good song.
No.
Yeah, that is
it's
a good song.
Not.
That's a great song.
That's their disco era.
It's still a good song.
It's a disco song. I was made for 12th Dynasty.
I was made Lick for loving you, baby.
Lick it up is.
Oh, I thought that was the Bay City Rollers.
For loving me.
2000 Man's a great tune.
DAY.
It's the same fucking band.
S-A-T-U-Y.
They ripped off the Bay City Rollers.
And what was 2000 Man's a great song by Ace Frehley. Ace probably became my favorite member.
Really?
Fucking.
Yeah. Ace was the coolest.
Paul's coming out.
Yes, he was.
His chest hair.
Sure. Yay.
Jesus.
I was made for loving you. Yeah, so small.
This is their disco song, right?
Yeah.
The drum machine.
Yeah, a little bass.
Drum machine, very simple guitar.
Yeah.
It's a good tune. Come on.
Is it?
Yes.
Yeah, dude.
This is a montage song. Who are you kidding?
Da, 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 da.
It's a montage.
Yeah, it's a montage song.
Yeah. And then when the hook kicks
this
in.
This is 79.
Shut up, Sam. Yeah, I know what you're doing.
Sam doesn't like this, but I do.
I do like it.
I want to see it kick in. That kick in. Girl, you were made for me. Here we go.
I was made for loving you, baby. You were made for loving me.
Come on, baby.
No.
Boring.
No, no, don't hit the clip because then I can't hear the song.
Okay, fuck it.
No, you're hitting the buttons. I can't hear the song.
What the Christ.
I hate you.
Make it all come true. Oh, shut up. Turn this off.
This is Paul.
Yay. Book Logic. I got me a hex bug crab. I guess it's one of these tiny little robotic things that kind of move around. Is that what it is? Yeah. Thank you, Coke Logic.
It just moves?
Yeah, it kind of... It. Remember that movie with Gene Simmons and Magnum P.I.?
Yeah.
Remember that one? And they had the little mechanical, little crabby robot things that walked around. It looks like a miniature version of one of those.
Does it do anything? Does it help you with it?
What's it supposed to do? It's fucking 1 inch tall. It's supposed to get me coffee.
It's like a wind-up car?
No, it's a little crabby thing.
It's
a little mechanical crab. Well, it's cool because it's like robotics. It's got some kind of robotics. I don't know what it does, though.
That's the question.
Except walk. Does it like have any sensors on it where if it goes to a wall, will it turn around?
What makes that not a child's toy?
Not that that matters, because I like child toys.
Uh-huh.
Runaway was the movie. Yes, the movie Runaway. Button. Yeah.
Did Gene Simmons have a real role in that, or was it like a tiny?
He was the villain.
Oh, he was.
He was the guy. I thought he was kind of, at the time, I remember seeing that movie and thinking, oh, Gene Simmons did a pretty good job.
Yeah.
But, and then I watched it, more recently, and all he did was kind of make villainous eyes and look back and forth a lot.
Your expectations of him were so low.
Yeah,
that
yeah.
In the beginning, you're like, all right, he pulled it off. All right.
And now if I watch that, I just see the scumbag that tried to fucking hone in on my chick.
Do you have any of that on the... what's it called?
Runaway. The movie was Runaway with Gene Simmons. So get a Gene Simmons part in the clip. And we'll see some acting by Gene Simmons in Runaway. What year was that? 84.
Yeah, that was a big deal to Kiss fans. You couldn't believe he was doing that.
Oh, my God. That's like a big movie at the time.
I don't remember. I don't know if I ever saw it. I didn't want to see Gene doing this silliness.
Tom Selleck going up in the elevator.
You're going to have to help me. I don't know if this is a correct scene or not.
It might not be a scene where we actually see Gene talk. I think we're going to see some fighting, a little action. He doesn't have his big boots on, though. And he doesn't breathe fire or spit blood or stick his tongue out.
Was his name the demon in it?
No, it wasn't the demon either.
What was it?
So Kiss fans didn't like this? That he did this?
Really? 84?
I didn't know if Kiss fans did.
Why didn't you like it?
Because it was Gene doing an acting thing.
See, the little crabby things. Out. They got the little crabby things. Where is Gene?
I just wanted to see him as the demon.
It's all this Tom Selleck.
Yeah.
Enough with Tom Selleck.
Gene's more handsome.
You think Gene... Oh, here's this. Yeah, there's Gene.
Oh.
Look, he's looking maniacal.
Yeah.
He's just squatting down over him.
But not good enough. Enjoy the view.
Uh-oh. What happened, Gene? He's plummeting in an elevator.
Wow.
They're fighting.
No. I hope Gene doesn't have a concert to go to. They're falling.
Uh-oh. The robots are going to get Gene.
What the fuck is this awful movie?
No, the little robot things are sticking them with acid. And they inject acid into you.
Why didn't he just get up? Why is he laying there?
It's going into his neck.
This is like a Mystery Science Theater movie.
Oh, it would be great on Mystery Science
Theater. Isn't it amazing how bad the fucking robots are in 84, even?
They were terrible.
They're these little weird... They look like napkin holders attacking Gene Simmons.
Here goes Gene. Gene's dead. He got injected with acid. Spoiler alert, Gene dies in the movie because he tried to steal Tom Selleck's girlfriend.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I mean, lesson learned, never mess with Tom Selleck.
Never. He's always going to win.
I'm just happy he's okay in real life.
Yeah. Wow.
That's all that matters.
Yeah, they did have, like, heat-seeking bullets in the gun that Gene had. Like, the bullet would go around the corners and see the people in, like, this weird fucking view. And then,
future?
Yeah, see? Doesn't it look like one?
I suppose it looks like it, but I still don't understand.
I want to get a bunch of them and then lay on the floor and go, and have them attack me.
I'd like that, too. And then while you're doing it, I slowly back a car over you.